101.7.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to doubleheader action involving the Princeton Tigers and the Hardin-Central Bulldogs. We are live from the final day of 2015 North Central Missouri College Holiday Hoops. Have studio engineer Bebop and Dave Berkebile back at the KGOZ studios, not very far away from us here in downtown Trenton, Missouri. Logan Demsit should be running the camera off to my immediate left trackside from the Ketcham Center. Three more games to go. Actually, I think it may be four. We'll double check that here as we can report a game that just got over, the big school game of the day. It's a Northwest Missouri, Northeast Missouri matchup here in North Central Missouri with Lafayette, the Fighting Irish, defeating the Kirksville Lady Tigers 42-31. And there are four games left to go here at Holiday Hoops. I thought that was the case. Thought I misspoke when I said three, and indeed I did. As coming up, it's the Princeton girls and boys set to take on the Hardin-Central Bulldogs. Not the first time these teams have had a rodeo with one another here at Holiday Hoops. I do remember specifically a thrilling Princeton-Hardin-Central boys game from a year ago, and not quite as clear on the memory bank, but I believe Princeton and Hardin-Central have seen each other on the girls' side as well. Coming up later tonight, out of the GRC, the King City Wildcats take on the Tigers of Pilot Grove. The girls' game is scheduled for 5:30, with the boys' game at 7 o'clock. About 5.5 minutes here from the opening tip for the girls' contest between the Hardin-Central Lady Bulldogs and the Princeton Lady Tigers. Hardin-Central, one of those programs that 90% of the time you can figure them being above average, and maybe a good 20 to 30% of the time potential of being elite. I think they're in the more above average category this year out of the CLAA, but above average, that means that Princeton, you play a team like that, you got to play well. So Princeton's looking at that opportunity today. Princeton has a couple of wins pre-Christmas this season. Princeton's had one of those seasons where if you look at the teams they've played and you pick the games before the season, probably pretty close to saying that Princeton's won the games that you figured they win, and they'd struggled in the games that you figured they'd struggle in a little bit. This is not the first game for Princeton at Holiday Hoops, as the Lady Tigers matched up with Linn County. It was a shorthanded Princeton team on the 18th, a Saturday before Christmas, 2 weeks ago to the day. And Princeton didn't play too badly. Struggled in the first half, surged in the second half against a state-ranked Linn County girls squad. Princeton ended up a little bit short, 55-47. Princeton boys then lost to Linn County in a close game later that day. Princeton boys going to play Hardin-Central coming up here at 4 o'clock. We are live with both audio and video today. If you want to check out our video on KGOZ TV, go bring up YouTube.com, go search for KTTN Radio, and then look for the option. There'll probably be about 40, 45 different videos there. Only one of them will have that little button. I think it's a green button, indicates live video. Should be very easy to find. There'll be a Princeton Hardin-Central logo with it. Our video guy, Randall Mann, put that together here in the last couple hours. So we will have video of the Princeton Hardin-Central doubleheader as well on KGOZ TV. We're back in 3 minutes with the starting lineups in the opening tip for Princeton Hardin-Central. It's girls action on the final day of Holiday Hoops from the Ketcham Center as we bring you into the second day of 2016 on Hot Country Z 101.7.
New year, new chance to get organized. Going on now at the Home Depot with totes, shelves, and everything you need to organize every room in your home for less. A lot less. Like the HDX 5-shelf storage unit. That's a special buy for just $29.97. You save over $9. Let's do this. At the Store More, Save More event going on now at the Home Depot. More saving, more doing. U.S. only while supplies last. See store for details.
I've smoked a lot and quit a lot, but got nowhere. It's hard. Then my daughter was born. Now I have the best reason why to quit in the world. I just need the right how. I want this time to be my last time. That's why I choose Nicoderm CQ.
The Nicoderm CQ patch has unique extended-release technology that helps prevent you from all the time. Nicoderm CQ for a chance to win valuable prizes. Uses directly. Behavior support increases chances of success.
just found out about this great business that provides home health care located in Trenton. It's called Serplink Health Care.
What do you mean you just found out? They've been here 40 years.
But I never needed them, so I never noticed them. Now with Mom ill and Dad getting a joint replacement, I need them. They have great nurses, therapists, and aides, and work with our doctors to provide excellent care at home.
Aren't they in the Goldeneye House on 9th Street?
Yeah, I called them 359-4218. It's hard taking care of your parents' home care needs, but Serplink makes it really simple. Give them a call.
Did you know that in Princeton is a long-time proud supporter of their hometown Princeton Tigers? Indeed, always featuring great deals on their favorite, like this, the beef. Visit located at 107 North Washington Street. Says no Tigers.
We are Missouri.
Right, attacking the defense. Now we'll set things up from left of the circle. Pass the ball to the wing for Gooden, to the baseline to Buttrey. Buttrey off to Enright. Enright to the free throw line to Thomas. Thomas to the right wing for Gooden. Now back to the left side. Here's Enright. Jumper from 17. Off the back iron. No good. Rebound saved inbounds nicely by Hardin-Central's Logsdon. Tosses it into the teammate, DeMint. And DeMint hands the ball off to Paul. Paul with the basketball for the Bulldogs goes to Manchester from the right wing. Manchester fires the ball baseline right for DeMint. Fadeaway bank shot, no good. And over the back's going to be called on the rebound against Julia Finley. So Finley kind of was flat-footed there going for that rebound. It wasn't really able to get in the air with a huge leap and ended up banging into the back of her defender. 6:23 to go and a scoreless first quarter pass toward Buttrey. Knocked away. Princeton fortunate to get it back. Gooden gets it back off the Hardin deflection. Now here's Buttrey at the elbow. Turns from the free throw line, drives it inside the paint, passes it to Thomas. Goes baseline, goes up for the layup and is fouled. Kind of a ragged looking play, but Princeton got it to work. Thomas got as far as she could go before drawing the double team and then just fired the ball baseline. And Jalen Thomas likes that baseline well for Princeton. She's developed a nice little game from about 10 feet in from the right baseline as she hits the free throw down. So Stevie Thomas has first point of the ball game, 1-0. Lady Tigers on top, free throw number two. Off the side of the rim, no good. 1-0, Princeton the score. 2 minutes deep into the first quarter of play. Point guard for Hardin-Central is Addie Paul. Her pass knocked away by Thomas into the hands of Princeton, then losing the ball, trying to fire a bounce pass on the run was Cody Buttrey. Buttrey is trying to wrap that pass to the baseline to Peyton Gooden. The ball goes out of bounds. Back over to Hardin-Central. Good idea, bad execution there for Princeton. 5:50 to go in the first quarter. There's a steal and then taken right back away by Hardin-Central. Almost thrown away by Paul. Now she gets the ball to the wing for DeMint, and Ashlyn DeMint fires and hits on the three. So DeMint had the quick trigger there and got the three ball to work. 3-1 Lady Bulldogs with the lead. Princeton with it. Here is Enright. Enright, left of the key, Johnson, baseline, Thomas. Thomas left corner, now to Enright. Enright tried to put the ball on the deck, had the ball knocked away by DeMint. Enright gets it back, gives the ball ahead of the key for Gooden. Gooden to Johnson, now to Buttrey, goes to Enright, drives it baseline and traveled as she got cut off neatly there by Julia Finley, moving her feet along that left baseline about 3 feet away from the rim. 5:11 to go in the opening quarter of play. Hardin-Central's ladies with a 3-1 lead over Princeton. Ball's going to be lobbed in the front court to an open. Ashlyn DeMint, she'll drive it hard to the baseline, throws the ball away. Thomas stepped into the passing lane. The ball loose on the floor, picked up by Enright, wrestled for by DeMint. They tie it up. And it will be Hardin-Central basketball. Video's up and going? Yes? You can go to YouTube right now. Go to KGOZ TV. Go to KTTN Radio on YouTube. And you can watch the game from the comfort of home or your iPhone or whatever your choice of 21st century technology. Here's Thomas getting the ball to Buttrey. Princeton down two. Buttrey had the ball knocked away. Quick hands there by Hardin-Central. That seems to be the calling card of the Lady Bulldogs. Quick hands defensively, making life difficult on the Tigers. The ball goes into the front court for DeMint. Here's DeMint from the right wing. Picks up the dribble, looks inside, doesn't have anything open there. Now DeMint's going to just pivot with the basketball and find her point guard, Manchester. Manchester to Paul. Now baseline, Logsdon back to Manchester. Head of the key for DeMint. DeMint holding the ball overhead. Snaps the ball baseline to Logsdon. Logsdon had the ball knocked away as a reach and foul is going to be called. No. Thought there was going to be a reach and foul going against Enright, but instead, 3 seconds called against Hardin-Central. That summons Vivian Allen, who has the role of sixth girl for this squad, into the ballgame for Princeton. The talented sophomore off the bench of head coach Wade Hall at the midway point of the first quarter. Here's the aforementioned Allen with a basketball, fires it off to Enright. Three-pointer barely skimmed the rim, rebound to Thomas, but it clicked off her hand and landed on the baseline. So an opportunity for an offensive rebound goes by the wayside for the Tigers. Hardin-Central with it. In the backcourt, here's DeMint. Ashlyn DeMint lobs the ball front court to Paul. Paul tries to get it inside to Logsdon and knocking the ball away. Well defensively for Princeton is the senior guard, Maddie Enright. 3:54 to go in the opening quarter of play. 3-1, Lady Tigers down. Hardin-Central trying to make it a two-possession lead. From the corner, jumper by Paul. Good. A 16-footer from the left corner. Finds the bottom of the hole for Addie Paul, and it's 5-1 in favor of Hardin. 3:40 to go in the opening quarter of play. Princeton still looking for its first field goal. Here's Enright going left side. Allen thought about the jumper, then closed on quickly. Gets the ball to Enright. Now back to Allen. Allen pivots, gives it back to Enright on the bounce. Now to Allen. Allen left side, fakes the shot, drives the ball to the elbow, swings the ball right of the circle into the hands of Gooden. Gooden to the left side. Allen jumper by Vivian. No good. Rebound fought for inside. Grabbed by Hardin-Central. Good board in traffic for Finley. Ball to Logsdon. Logsdon attacks. And as she tried to get rid of the ball, she mishandled it. And that forces a double dribble. Logsdon saw Kylie Manchester open inside, but could not make the pass in full gallop cleanly. 5-1, Princeton down. Here's Thomas from the right corner. On the give and go, goes to the low block to Allen. Ball knocked away. Oldest play in the book. Almost worked there for Princeton. The old give and go. Knocked away out of bounds by Hardin-Central. Princeton with it. Ball tipped into the hands of Enright from the left wing. Enright to the right wing for Allen. Back to Enright. Now to Buttrey. Buttrey to left side. Jumper by Gooden. Air ball. Over the hoop. Takes one hop and goes out of bounds. Back over to the orange and black. 2:48 to go in a low scoring first quarter. Hardin-Central with a 5-1 lead over Princeton. Ball flung to the timeline. It's loose. Grabbed by Thomas. So Hardin-Central turns it over. Thomas gets the ball off to Allen. Here's Allen to Enright, left side jumper, no, it rattled and would not fall. Princeton's had some good looks. Haven't been able to get that shot in yet. 5-1, Hardin-Central with the lead. Ball goes into the front court, Manchester. Now Manchester off to DeMint. DeMint trapped along the near sideline by good Tiger defense. Lobs the ball to head of the key to Paul. Paul resets for Hardin, 2:20 to go in the opening quarter. Ball goes into the right corner for Logsdon. Logsdon to the low block, turning, firing, and missing is Finley. Got her own rebound, fighting for it against Buttrey. Stops, shoots, scores it over Cody. Julia Finley with the bucket for Hardin-Central, and it's 7-1 Lady Bulldogs. 2 minutes to go in the opening quarter. Here's a pass going to the free throw line to Buttrey. Swings it to the right wing for Allen. Now to Gooden, tried to get it inside of Thomas. Ball knocked away, loose on the floor, out of bounds. Last touch by the Bulldogs. Princeton possession with 1:51 to go in a Hardin-dominated first quarter. 7-1, Bulldogs with the lead. Pass goes into the left corner. Here's Allen driving an igloo double team. Swings the pass to the wing for Enright. Enright goes to the right side now to Gooden. Back to Enright. Enright to Buttrey at the free throw line. Buttrey back to Enright. Launches the three. Head of the key. Missed it. Spun out. Rebound Thomas. And her putback is no good. But a foul whistle against Hardin-Central. Best offense for Princeton in the first quarter has been the offensive rebounding ability of Jalen Stevie Thomas. The foul goes against Kylie Manchester of Hardin-Central, her first. Thomas to the free throw line. Free throw number one is an air ball. No good. She'll try one more with 90 seconds to go in the first quarter. Checking in for Princeton, Savannah Milburn, replacing Dakota Buttrey. Second free throw coming up for Thomas. Eyes the bucket, fires that one, puts it in. One of two for Thomas, who has both Princeton points. And it's 7-2, Hardin-Central. 90 seconds to go in the first. Along the timeline, here's Manchester. Fires front court, tipped by Milburn into the hands of a teammate, and there's a tie-up. Trying to rip that ball away was Vivian Allen of Princeton, but she got into a lock position with Ashlyn DeMint of Hardin-Central. One couldn't rip the ball away from the other. It'll be Princeton ball on the alternating arrow with 80 seconds to go in the first quarter. Here's Enright to the right wing for Gooden. Now to Thomas, back to Enright. Head of the key, Allen. Left side, Gooden. Baseline, Thomas. Layup, no good. A little bit off balance as she released that one. The rebound is claimed by Hardin-Central. The outlet pass goes to DeMint with 1 minute to go in the first quarter. Here's DeMint to Paul. Goes baseline. Jumper from there. Skims the back rim. No good by Manchester. Rebound to Milburn. Hands the ball off to Enright. Enright from left to right on your dial. Races into the front court. Goes on top for Gooden. Left side to Allen. Vivian. Shot is good. Vivian Allen hits the 16-footer from the left wing. She's on the board. And the Tigers get their first field goal of the first quarter. 7-4. Hardin-Central with the lead. 32 seconds to go until the quarter break. Pass goes baseline, caught by Finley off the bobble. Finley puts the ball on the deck, works inside the paint, stops, pops, misses on the seven-footer. Rebound, Enright. Princeton building a little bit of momentum, gets a bucket, now a stop. Enright thought about the three, passes it off to Allen. Allen back to Enright. Inside Thomas, the catch, the layup, no. Rebound fought for inside. Thomas has it with six to go in the quarter. Swings it off to Enright. Enright now off to Allen. Allen with one, puts up the shot at the horn, and it's blocked away. Hands straight up, the referee said there for Lacey Logsdon, so no whistle on the shot attempt. We are through one quarter of play. It's Hardin-Central 7 and Princeton 4. We'll have more Holiday Hoops basketball in a minute on KGOZ-TV and Z101.7.
Whoa, whoa. What?
Are we recording a new auto shop ad?
Well, yeah, it's about time, don't you think?
True that, but the auto shop has been at 130 South Highway 65 since 2012.
Shut the front door. Jim Shaw, the best auto mechanic in the world, has been at the auto shop that long?
Yes, ma'am. Well, he's the best mechanic around my house anyway, and I wouldn't trust anyone but him and the auto shop crew under the hood of my car, and neither should you.
The auto shop, 130 South Highway 65. Give them a call today, 359-3400.
No question about it, weeds were bad this year, and they ended up costing. This is the 2016 is LibertyLink soybeans. This is Joe Mershman. By using the LibertyLink system for Mershman seeds, you can control those tough weeds. And you and I both know that no weeds mean big yields. So when the big seed companies come around, tell them thanks, but no thanks. Because you've got real solutions that will make you more money on Mershman seeds.
My Party Station,
Pod Country, 101.7.
Welcome back to the Ketcham Community Center. 7-4 as we get the second quarter underway. We'll get you a Missouri update here shortly. Tigers playing their final non-conference game before SEC play and leading Savannah State late in the first half. Hardin-Central goes right inside to start the second quarter. Mackenzie McBee makes the catch, tried for the bank shot in traffic, wasn't able to get it to go, draws the foul against Princeton Savannah Milburn. First against Savannah, McBee to the free throw line, toss up, swish. So Milburn hit with the foul and McBee hits the free throw. 8-4 the lead for the Lady Bulldogs. Second free throw. McBee's going to miss that one. Short rebound. Save but thrown right inbounds. Nice play by Logsdon but threw it right into the Tigers. And traveling with it as she worked into the front court was Vivian Allen. Vivian sensed that she had a hard-charging Lady Bulldog right behind her, and that's kind of freaked her out a tad. She tried to pick up the dribble but lost her balance and traveled. 8-4 Hardin-Central with the lead. And the basketball here early in the second quarter. The ball goes to the right wing for DeMint. DeMint goes baseline to McBee. And a foul's going to be whistled against Milburn. So Milburn having some trouble keeping McBee out of the lane here early in the second quarter. Substitutions in for Coach Hall. It'll be Cody Buttry and Haley Johnson checking in for Big Blue. Pass goes right inside. There's the catch and the layup put up and in. By Logsdon. Logsdon got inside Thomas, got the inside position, and As far as Princeton was concerned, that's too easy of a layup there off the inbounds. 10-4, Tigers down with the basketball. Enright, her pass to the wing, picked off. With it for the Bulldogs is Addie Paul. Hardin-Central playing those wing passes aggressively as Paul works into the front court, picks up the dribble, goes to the right wing for McBee. McKenzie puts the ball on the deck, now picks up the dribble, launches the ball awkwardly to the near sideline, saved inbounds, but then grabbed by 2-on-1 break, pass goes to the wing, and a foul's going to be whistled against Hardin-Central before Princeton's Haley Johnson was able to release a layup attempt. Kylie Manchester with a foul for Hardin-Central. It was not a bad foul for Hardin-Central. It stopped a 2-on-1 break, and Princeton does not get free throws. So the pass is going to come inbounds here from Haley Johnson. Let's get you that Missouri score. It's 39-25, Mizzou over Savannah State. About a minute and a half left to go in the first half. There's a three ball from the left wing, nailed by Princeton's Vivian Allen. Right off the inbounds pass, Allen has five, and it's 10-7, Tigers down by three. Hardin-Central with the basketball up the near sideline, gallops Addie Paul. Works between the circles, being guarded very tightly here by Princeton's Enright. Paul got it on the give and go to Mint. Back to Paul, her layup no good. And the baseline rebound was grabbed by McBee. But we get a foul on the play against Hardin-Central for a push. So McBee got the rebound, but the referee was standing right there, said it was not done cleanly. McBee called for the personal foul, her first. And here comes Princeton with a little bit of momentum now, down by three. Pass goes to Johnson, now to Buttry. Buttry from the elbow, swings it to the right wing. Jumper by Allen's up and good. Vivian Allen with her third bucket. Princeton's offense going through the sophomore right now. Allen with seven, and it's 10-9, Hardin-Central. 6 minutes to go in the first half. With the basketball, it's Addie Paul of the Lady Bulldogs. Coach Kenny Lehman doesn't like where the momentum is heading right now, and he calls timeout. 5:55 to go in the first half of play. It's 10-9, Hardin-Central over Princeton. We're back in a minute on KGOZ-TV.
Facing tough family choices, choose Servlink Home Care's aides and nurses for quality care at home. Need physical therapy to rehab an injury or surgery? Get better and get stronger at home. How about safety when you can't be there? Lifeline is there 24/7 with help at the touch of a button. Call Servlink today at 359-4218. We help people live safely at home. Servlink Home Care, providing the simple pleasures of home since 1973.
Big G Foodland in Princeton is a longtime proud supporter of their hometown Princeton Tigers. For tailgating before the next Tiger game, swing by Big G, always featuring great deals on your favorites, like ribs and beef. Visit BigGFoodland.com to see the latest ad specials, recipes, and ways to eat smarter and healthier. Big G Foodland, conveniently located at 107 North Washington Street in Princeton, says go Tigers.
Nice looking screen along the far sideline sends us back into live action. Kylie Manchester got ran over. Vivian Allen tried to go right through the screen. That's one that wasn't called out well by the Princeton teammates. Now there's a steal inside. Thomas tips the ball to Allen. Ball knocked away from behind. It'll be taken by Hardin-Central along the right baseline. Here's Addie Paul. She'll swing it the other direction to Mint. DeMint works up the far sideline for Hardin-Central. 5.5 left to go in a topsy-turvy first half of play. Ball to the baseline goes to McBee, and she traveled with it as she tried to pivot and pass the ball back to the perimeter. Pilot Grove Tigers are here wearing the... I'll take that back. It may not be Pilot Grove. I just realized King City's going to be playing Pilot Grove, and King City, last I checked, wears the purple and gold, so I think... A few of the King City ladies are watching here on the Princeton side. Off to the near left corner of the floor with the basketball for Princeton. It's Buttry. Buttry free throw line. Bounce pass goes off to Allen. Now Allen off to Hennis. Now to Allen. Lobs it off to Ashley Hennis from the head of the key. Hennis swings it right side. Now underneath to Johnson. Catch. Layup. Good. Good patient ball movement there for Princeton. Waited for a good shot. Haley Johnson got it. Banks it in, and it's 11-10. Princeton with the lead for the first time today. Here's Addie Paul racing up the far sideline for Hardin-Central. Works the ball into the right corner. Now passes to Logsdon at the right elbow. Logsdon looking for the high-low pass. Goes baseline. Jumper by Manchester. No good. Rebound inside is claimed by Ashton Markley. Gets the ball out to DeMint for a three ball off the iron. No good. Rebound chased down by Ashley Hennis of Princeton. Hennis seeing some playing time here in the early portion of the second quarter. Pass goes off to the wing for Gooden. Tipped inside. Princeton got a great break. The ball was tipped right into the hands of Haley Johnson off a Hardin-Central player, and Haley is there to dump it in for two. Johnson with back-to-back bucket makes it 13-10. Lady Tigers. DeMint with the basketball for Hardin. Takes the ball into the left corner. Picks up the dribble. Lobs the ball inside and unable to make the catch. There was McBee. The ball is loose. Taken by Princeton. Princeton's calling card needs to be defense this year if the Tigers are going to find any success in the always rugged GRC. And today, Princeton has to feel very proud of the defensive effort. Princeton got behind by a little bit, but Princeton's defense has been solid and salty. It's making life difficult right now in the Hardin-Central offense. Tiger offense has given Princeton a three-point advantage. Losing the ball there is Hennis, but she managed to stay with it and tip the ball to Buttry. Now Buttry lost it, tried to get it back, and we're going to get a foul whistled against DeMint. So Princeton just out there about 16 feet away from the hoop, just trying to hold the ball, not necessarily do anything fancy with it. And Hardin Central's there saying, we're not going to let you do that. We're going to be pesky. Foul against DeMint is her first. Here's Buttry, right wing pass, launching the three ball off the front rim. Gooden, weak side rebound to Hardin Central. Finley gets some room in the paint. Ball fired up the far sideline to Logsdon. Logsdon back to DeMint. DeMint into the front court, picks up the dribble, goes to Logsdon at the high post. Dumps it down low for the turnaround bank shot. Good by Julia Finley. Finley kept those hands high, got that pass about 3 feet out, just kind of pivoted toward the paint and was able to hit the square perfectly to cut Princeton's lead to one. Here's Hennis trying to get the ball to Buttry and knocking the ball out of bounds for Hardin Central is Addie Paul. Princeton will have a toss in with Peyton Gooden. Gets the ball to Buttry in the right corner. Now Buttry to Enright. Back to the corner where Gooden's shot attempt is swatted out of bounds by the leaping right hand of Addie Paul. So Paul with the defensive play for Hardin. Keeps it with Princeton. Pass goes right of the circle. Now on top for Enright. Enright to Buttry. Buttry from the right elbow. Surveys the court. Gets the ball back to Enright. Enright from right of the circle. Didn't like what she had there. Will work the ball to the head of the key and reset the offense. She goes the left side to Gooden. Back to Enright. Enright lobbing it to Buttry. There's another a little simple pass play that Hardin Central is there to swat it away. Ball goes the left side to Gooden. Back to Enright. Enright to the right wing for Hennis. Hennis into the corner. Now to Enright. Jumper from distance. No good. Skims the rim and the rebound to Hardin Central's Julia Finley. To DeMint, up the far sideline, here's Logsdon. Logsdon lobs it down low, then the catch and the layup in transition. Nicely done, is up and good by McBee. Mackenzie McBee with three, and the lead goes back to the Bulldogs at 14-13. 2:14 to go in the opening half. Pass goes to the wing, caught by Hennis. Hennis off balance, somehow avoided the travel, got it back to the wing for the three ball. It's off the back rim and no good for Peyton Gooden. The ball is out of bounds, last touch by Hardin Central. 2:04 to go in the first half. 14-13, the lead for the Bulldogs over the Tigers. The pass goes to Enright. Her shot no good from the right wing. Princeton's not hitting a whole heck of a lot here from 15 feet out in the first half. As the ball goes to Logsdon, reverses it off left of the key for Paul. Her pass knocked away by Buttry, and here comes Cody with a head of steam. She tries to get the ball front court to her senior point guard. That was a tough pass. Was guarded pretty well. There was Maddie Enright, and the ball is out of bounds. Last touched by Enright. 1:46 to go in the first half. The Princeton turnover gives it back over to Hardin Central. Here's Logsdon. Logsdon to DeMint. Back to Logsdon. Logsdon with some room up the right sideline. Stops. Pass the ball inside to McBee. She takes one dribble. Got it into deeper traffic and lost the ball out of bounds. Pretty good defense. McBee thought she could take one dribble, and that would be enough to get a good angle for a layup. It all would have worked except for Buttry was right there waiting for her, and it caught McBee by surprise, and she lost the ball out of bounds off her kneecap. Here's Haley Johnson with the ball in the left corner for Princeton. Gets the ball off to Enright. Enright now to Johnson. Left baseline jumper good. Haley Johnson connects from 14 feet away. Her third bucket of the quarter gives Princeton the 15-14 lead. Pressure in the backcourt. DeMint guarded tightly by Enright. DeMint gets the ball to Logsdon. Logsdon still in the backcourt. Now dribbles it to the frontcourt. Gets it back to DeMint. DeMint from right of the circle. Puts the ball on the deck. Dribbles the ball to the head of the key. Now to the three-point arc. Goes to the right wing. Picks up the dribble from there. Looks inside. Guarded well by Princeton. DeMint gets the pass off into the hands of Paul. Paul goes into the right corner. Guarded tightly. Pass goes inside for the baseline catch by Finley. And on the catch, foul whistled against Princeton. Looks like some fatigue showing there for the Hardin-Central ladies. Lacey Logsdon, Mackenzie McBee, both bent over with hands on their knees trying to find some oxygen. So the halftime break may come at a good time here for Hardin-Central. Pass inside is going to be loose on the baseline. Almost stolen away by Vivian Allen. Couldn't quite get control of it, and the ball will stay with Hardin. 40 seconds to go in the opening quarter. Ball goes into the right corner for DeMint. DeMint goes baseline and lost the ball out of bounds, and she lost it off her own body. So turnover gives it over to the Lady Tigers. Princeton down a point, or up a point, I should say. 33 seconds to go in the first half. 15-14, Lady Tigers up. Here's Vivian Allen from the left wing. Allen to Enright. Princeton's going to hold it for one shot. Enright's going to hold the ball on her right hip. Now she'll be given a little bit of pressure by Paul. That at least forces the pass to avoid the five-second call. As Enright gets the ball to Allen, back to Enright. Enright from in front of the timeline goes left side pass to Allen in the left corner. Vivian works to the elbow, puts up the shot, and traveled with it with 3 seconds to go in the first half. Full court pressure shown by Princeton. The pass will come in for DeMint. Fires the ball up the far sideline. Knocked out of bounds at the buzzer by Princeton's Peyton Gooden. We go to the halftime locker room. These teams are very well matched with one another. The skill set similar and weaknesses similar for both teams. And that means we got ourselves a tight duel. It's the Princeton Lady Tigers up by one at the half over the Hardin-Central Lady Bulldogs. 15-14 is the score. We'll take a two-minute timeout. We'll be back with scoring summary next on Hot Country Z101.7 and KGOZ-TV.
New year, new chance to get organized during the Store More, Save More event going on now at the Home Depot. With totes, shelves, and everything you need to organize every room in your home for less, a lot less. Like the HDX 5 Shelf Storage Unit. It's a special buy for just $29.97. You save over $9. Let's do this at the Store More, Save More event going on now at the Home Depot. More saving, more doing. U.S. only while supplies last. See store for details.
I smoked a lot and quit a lot, but got nowhere. It's hard. Then my daughter was born. Now I have the best reason why to quit in the world. I just need the right how. I want this time to be my last time. That's why I choose Nicoderm CQ.
The Nicoderm CQ patch has unique extended-release technology that helps prevent your urge to smoke all day. Tweet hashtag what's your why at Nicoderm CQ for a chance to win valuable prizes. Use it directly. Behavior support increases chances of success.
North Central Missouri College is proud to be a sponsor of high school athletes playing on area sports teams. As NCMC observes its 90th anniversary, we are proud of NCMC's strong legacy and continued growth. If you're thinking of returning to college, NCMC is an excellent choice. With newly expanded online degree programs and highly competitive tuition, visit ncmissouri.edu. Call 359-3948. Learn how NCMC can prepare you for the future.
We are Missouri Farm Bureau Insurance, and we're for the people of Missouri. We're for kayakers, car dealers, grocery baggers, and mail carriers. We're for teachers, preachers, students, and singers. Armed service members, you bet we're for you. We're for people who shake your hand and say hello, not because they know you, but because they don't. We're for brewmasters, stockbrokers, beauty queens, and truck drivers. And don't worry, we're still for farmers, too. Whatever you do, if you're a Missourian, we're for you.
I'm Marcia Cox, your Missouri Farm Bureau Insurance Agent. And if you're in Mercer County, I've got you covered.
Princeton Tiger Basketball here on Hot Country, KGOZ, Gallatin, Chillicothe.
Score at the break, the Princeton Lady Tigers leading the Hardin-Central Lady Bulldogs 15-14. Scoring summary looks like this. We'll go through the quarter-by-quarter scoring first. Princeton had a little bit of a neutral start, you know, which is not the best start in the world, but Princeton defense in the first quarter held the Lady Tigers in it. Took 7 minutes for Princeton to put the ball in the hoop field goal-wise. Princeton trailed 7-4 at the end of one quarter. Princeton's offense able to get a couple of girls hot in the second quarter. One, Haley Johnson, the other, Vivian Allen. They combined for all 11 Tiger points in quarter number two. And that gave Princeton the 11-7 advantage in the second quarter and the one-point lead. So if you look at the two quarters as a whole, you can look at it and say Princeton's play was much, much better in the second quarter. Hardin-Central's play was pretty even. First quarter, second quarter matched one another. Princeton's play was just improved enough in quarter number two to give the Tigers the one-point lead at the break. Going to watch here some half-court shots. Just had a half-court shot bang off the back iron. There's a half-court shot. It's going to bang off the backboard. So we had an iron shot. We had a backboard shot. Neither worked here with the American Family Insurance shootout here at halftime of Holiday Hoops Contest. Scoring summary looks like this for Princeton. 7 points for Vivian Allen, 6 for Haley Johnson, and 2 points for Jalen Thomas. Hardin-Central, 4 from Julia Finley, 3 for Mackenzie McBee and Ashlyn Dement. Princeton's done a good job of keeping Lacey Logsdon well at bay in the first half. Logsdon with only 2 points, and 2 points on a first quarter field goal for Addie Paul. I'll send it back to the studio here for about 5 minutes. If you can, Mr. Bebop, we'll send things back about five blocks away to the Kate Josie studios for this timeout. We are at halftime. Princeton Lady Tigers leading the Hardin-Central Lady Bulldogs 15-14. We're back in five on KGLZ.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What? Are we recording a new auto shop ad?
Well, yeah, it's about time, don't you think?
True that, but the auto shop has been at 130 South Highway 65 since 2012.
Shut the front door. Jim Shaw, the best auto mechanic in the world, has been at the auto shop that long?
Yes, ma'am. Well, he's the best mechanic around my house anyway, and I wouldn't trust anyone but him and the auto shop crew under the hood of my car, and neither should you.
The auto shop, 130 South Highway 65. Give him a call today, 359-3400.
Lower commodity prices are making it difficult to make a profit. Looking at the markets, they've dropped almost in half from their highs. You're thinking, I need to cut costs. The fastest way to lower your cost per bushel is more yield. Hi, this is Joe Mershman from Mershman Seeds. What are the biggest factors that will affect your yield next year on your farm? Weeds? Sudden death? Mershman Seeds has the best solutions for the problems that are affecting your yield. You've been through this before, and we'll get through it again together.
Call Tom's Ag Spray, 875-2132. I just found out about this great business that provides home health care located in Trenton. It's called Surflink Home Care.
What do you mean you just found out? They've been here 40 years.
But I never needed them, so I never noticed them. Now with Mom ill and Dad getting a joint replacement, I need them. They have great nurses, therapists, and aides, and work with our doctors to provide excellent care at home.
Aren't they in the old ice house on 9th Street?
Yep, I called them, 359-4218. It's hard taking care of your parents' home care needs, but Surflink makes it really simple. Give them a call, 359-4218.
The Princeton School District Administration, faculty, and staff all give a collective salute to the young men and women competing on the various Tiger sports teams. You've put forth the extra hours and practices before the games and maintain a busy classroom and extracurricular schedule. Good luck to the Princeton Tigers. Do your best in athletics and academics. Tiger Nation is proud of all the Princeton students, athletes, their coaches, fans, and supporters. Princeton, R5 school.
Yeah, temperature at 37 degrees here at the KGOZ studios. Checking out your KGOZ forecast. It's being brought to you by McDonald's, where at McDonald's, get any size soft drink for $1. That's at McDonald's. I'm loving it. For tonight, clear skies, lows down around 18 degrees. We'll have west-southwest winds around 5 to 10 miles per hour, becoming north-northwest after midnight. Tomorrow for your Sunday, looking at sunny skies. Highs near 29 degrees, north winds of around 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tomorrow night, partly cloudy skies, lows down to 14 degrees, north-northwest winds of around 5 to 10 miles per hour. Monday's forecast says mostly sunny skies, highs near 28 degrees, north-northwest winds of around 5 to 10 miles per hour, becoming east-northeast in the afternoon. Monday night says mostly clear skies, lows down around 16 degrees, mostly sunny on Tuesday. Highs near 34 degrees, partly cloudy Tuesday night, lows down around 22. Partly sunny on your Wednesday hump day, highs near 36 degrees. Looking at Wednesday night, mostly cloudy skies, lows down around 28 degrees. Thursday has got a 30% chance of some rain under cloudy skies, highs near 39 degrees. Looking at Thursday night, 40% chance of some rain or even some freezing rain possible Thursday night, lows down around 30. And Friday's forecast calling for a 40% chance of some rain with highs near 38 degrees. It's currently 37 degrees here at Hot Country Z101.7. We'll send things back out to the Ketcham Community Center and more NCMC Holiday Hoops with Tom Johnson here in 1 minute on KGOZ 101.7.
New year, new chance to get organized during the Store More, Save More event going on now at the Home Depot. With totes, shelves, and everything you need to organize every room in your home for less, a lot less. Like the HDX 5 Shelf Storage Unit. It's a special buy for just $29.97. You save over $9. Let's do this at the Store More, Save More event going on now at the Home Depot. More saving, more doing. U.S. only while supplies last. See store for details.
I smoked a lot and quit a lot, but got nowhere. It's hard. Then my daughter was born. Now I have the best reason why to quit in the world. I just need the right how. I want this time to be my last time. That's why I choose Nicoderm CQ.
The Nicoderm CQ patch has unique extended-release technology that helps prevent your urge to smoke all day. Tweet hashtag what's your why at Nicoderm CQ for a chance to win valuable prizes. Use as directed. Behavioral support increases chances of success.
Station
Hot Country
Z101. Ready for a second half action, if not now, then shortly, as the Princeton Lady Tigers final huddle here with head coach Wade Hall before they hit the floor. Now Princeton is heading in that direction. Hardin-Central getting their last instructions here from the veteran head coach Kenny Lehman. Coach Lehman and his assistant Tom Twyman, they do double duty at Hardin-Central. They head coach assistant for both girls and boys. Princeton Hardin-Central boys play at the top of the hour about 4 o'clock here from the Ketcham Community Center. Then it's going to be Pilot Grove against King City in doubleheader action to wrap up this edition of Holiday Hoops for 2015-2016. In the front court, Ashlyn DeBint of Hardin-Central called for a quick traveling violation as we get half number two underway. Pass for Princeton goes to the wing for Gooden inside to Johnson. Johnson gets bumped and fouled at 12 seconds deep into the third quarter. It's Princeton 15, Hardin-Central 14. Full audio video today. We're on Z101.7 along with KGOZ TV. We'll try to effort here. I know the third quarter is underway, or the second half is underway. The quarters and the halves things, especially with women's basketball now going quarters, has me completely confused and befuddled. Halves still in men's college basketball, and I know Mizzou had the lead over Savannah State at the half. Didn't know the score. Last score update we had about a minute and a half to go, and the half, Mizzou's up by about 11. Try to get your score on that shortly. There's a jumper no good from the left side by Vivian Allen of Princeton. Good block out inside, and the rebound to Kylie Manchester of Hardin. Manchester gets the ball to Paul. Paul being pestered by Enright. That's where Princeton's strength comes from right there, that pestering man-to-man defense. But Princeton broke down there on the dribble drive. Pass went low block, caught and lobbed in by Julia Finley. Finley has six, and it's 16-15 Hardin. Here's Enright going left side to Allen. Vivian shot's going to skim the rim, no good. The rebound to Logsdon. Logsdon fires the outlet to DeMint. DeMint with the basketball for the orange and black. Picks up the dribble in the backcourt, lobs it up to near sideline to Paul. Swatted out of bounds by Enright. So Enright with the defensive play for Princeton. It'll stay with Hardin. Pass goes into Logsdon. Lacey Logsdon from the right side. Puts the ball on the deck. Gets the ball to DeMint. Three ball. Good from the right side. by Ashlyn DeMint. She did the same thing early in the first half. Caught the ball, had the look, hit the shot from 21. 19-15, Bulldogs up by four. Big possession here for the Tigers. Here's a three-pointer from the wing, no good by Gooden. Saved inbounds by Logsdon. Logsdon tips it to Paul. So the Bulldogs start the third quarter in a 5-0 run, get another stop. Pass goes to Paul in the front court, gets a screen, gets some room, drives against Johnson, fires the ball down the heart of the paint. Shot by Logsdon, no good. Block out inside, good rebound for Buttrey. Buttrey kept Logsdon from her own offensive board. The outlet pass goes to Gooden. Gooden swings it back to Johnson. Now Johnson to Gooden. Gooden from the right side. Puts the ball on the deck into the corner. Pass goes to Buttrey. Tip back into the hands of Gooden. Gooden on top for Enright. Enright goes left side to Allen. Back to Enright. Enright from the high free throw line. Works against the 2-3 zone. Pass goes off to Gooden. Back to Enright. Now left side to Allen. Allen to Enright. Free throw line jumper. No good off the side of the rim. So just about a foot and a half beyond the free throw line by Enright. Didn't seem to get her feet set really well on that shot. The rebound tipped out of bounds by the Bulldogs. Tigers keep possession. Pass goes to Allen in the left corner. Allen will lob it off to Enright. Here's Enright from the left wing. Works to the free throw line. And the ball slapped away from behind as that ball is out there pretty well away from the body of Enright. That gave Addie Paul a chance to strip it away from behind and out of bounds. Here's Buttrey. Buttrey's pass stolen away at the elbow. Tried to get it into the corner to Johnson, but the quick leaping hands there of Addie Paul swipes it away. Here's Paul into the front court. And trying to dig for a steal there was Maddie Enright. And the senior is going to be called for the personal for the Tigers. Maddie Enright called for the personal foul. Her first team foul number one in the second half against Princeton. Pass comes in for DeMint. Works around the defender. Lobs the ball inside to Finley. The catch and the layup. Princeton got caught with too many people around the driver and forgot the pass inside. Finley has a couple of buckets. And the Bulldogs have a 7-0 run to start the second half. It's Hardin-Central 21, Princeton 15. We're back to the Ketcham Community Center in 30 seconds on Hot Country Z101.7.
The Princeton School District Administration, faculty, and staff all give a collective salute to the young men and women competing on the various Tiger sports teams. You've put forth the extra hours in practices, before the games, and maintain a busy classroom and extracurricular schedule. Good luck to the Princeton Tigers. Do your best in athletics and academics. Tiger Nation is proud of all the Princeton students, athletes, their coaches, fans, and supporters. Princeton, R5 School.
Hot Country, Z101.7.
5:15 to go in the third quarter. The score here from Holiday Hoops as we head into the middle game of a seven-game slate to wrap up this year's event. Hardin-Central leading 3 minutes into the third quarter, 21-15. Hardin-Central has scored the first 7 points of the second half. There's an air ball put up by Maddie Enright. Had the good look from 16, but Maddie's been off with that jump shot all game long. She's yet to score for Princeton this afternoon. The air ball goes out of bounds, but Princeton gets a steal on the inbounds pass. Hardin-Central tried to lob it to Logsdon. Getting her hands on the ball was Haley Johnson, and then Logsdon in her efforts to get it back bumped Johnson in the back. That foul will be on Logsdon, but not a lot of fault there for Lacey. Was not a good pass in bounds. That pass is not good for Princeton. Over the head of Johnson, taken on the move by DeMint. DeMint drives, shoots, and hits the layup, cutting inside to Enright to get the angle and the buckets. Ashlyn DeMint now with 8. And the run is 9-0 to start the second half for Hardin-Central. Working to the elbow is Enright, and she had the ball stripped away as a reach and foul is whistled against the Bulldogs with 4:42 to go in the third. MU is playing better of late. I know it's against not so good competition, but hey, where Coach Anderson's program is, wins are wins. You're not going to apologize for them. Mizzou is well on their way to a win. 52-25 lead over Savannah State. That game being played down at Mizzou Arena, about 15 minutes to go. Baseline pass is tipped away from Haley Johnson. More good defense by the crew out of Ray County, Missouri. As Hardin-Central gets the ball front court to Mintz. DeMint gives it off to Paul. Hall, jab steps against end right, now takes the ball to the baseline. Runner is up off the back rim, no good. Rebound inside, grabbed by Longstead and Shear. Putback, no it. Banked off, spun around the rim and out. Rebound in the putback, no good. Foul whistled against Princeton. Unable to get the little left-handed bank shot to go was Kylie Manchester, but the foul goes against the Tigers, who are squarely on the struggle bus here in the third quarter. Similar to the first quarter for Princeton, but there's been one big difference, and it's a major one for Princeton. It's you can struggle offensively if your opponent is not hitting shots. Hardin-Central wasn't hit a lot of shots in the first quarter. Princeton struggled in the first quarter offensively. Princeton's having the same struggles in the third quarter. Hardin-Central is hitting shots in the third. First free throw, no good. Second free throw, good for Kylie Manchester. She gets her first point of the ball game. The foul was whistled against Peyton Gooden of Princeton, her first. Enright with the basketball for the Tigers, who are down by 9. 10-0 run to start the third quarter for Hardin-Central. Good Class 1 program out of the CLAA. Here's Enright. Got away with the travel. Goes baseline. Pass it inside. Thomas, her layup no good. Foul whistled against Hardin-Central with 3 3/4 minutes to go in the third. That'll be Logsden with the foul. Her second, team's fourth of the half. So free throw coming up for Thomas, up and good. Jalen Stevie Thomas now has 3 points, all from the free throw line. In for Coach Lehman is Mackenzie McBee, replacing Logsden. Second free throw for Thomas. Just got Princeton on the board for the first time since the halftime break. Up, good. Thomas hits the pair. We'll see if that stops some of the Tiger bleeding. 24-17. Harden's lead is 7. Pass in inbounds. Knocked away by Thomas. About right back from where the pass came to Addie Paul. Paul has it for Hardin-Central. Hard dribble up the near sideline. Tracked by Enright. Now cut off by Thomas. Cross-court pass picked off inside the paint. Good defense by the Tigers. Gooden has it with some room. Gooden will get a little screen. Now pass the ball to the elbow. Jumper from Johnson is good. Open jumper by Haley Johnson gives her 8, and Princeton is now on a 4-0 run as momentum shifts back to the Grand River Conference in this GRC-CLAA matchup. There's a traveling violation in the backcourt. Hardin-Central had one of their forwards handling the ball instead of the guards. That can be dangerous, and it was there for Coach Lehman's ball team. Julia Finley called for steps. So Princeton puts 4 in a row together now. Has a chance to make it a 6, maybe 7-0 run. Princeton within 5. Here's Thomas from the left corner. Lobbing it inside. Dangerous pass there. Caught in a triple team. And then trying to bounce the ball off of a Hardin-Central player to save the possession for Princeton was Peyton Gooden. Not sure if she was successful or not. The referee's going to say yes, she was. It'll stay with Princeton. As Gooden will toss the ball in from the left baseline. Gooden surveys the court, gets it into Enright. Enright from the left side takes the ball into the left corner, reverses position. Now goes to the right wing to Gooden. On top for Johnson. Now to Milburn. Milburn off to Enright. Drives off the pump fake. Her layup, no, it hit the bottom of the backboard and it bounces straight down to the floor. Taken by the orange and black. DeMint with the basketball with 2:40 to go in the third quarter. 24-19, the lead for Hardin-Central. As DeMint takes the ball to the left wing, picks up the dribble, double teamed by Tigers, and that forces a travel. More good defense for Princeton. Princeton has been uneven with its offensive productivity today, but the defense has generally kept Princeton in this one. Tigers down 5, 2:30 to go in the third. Enright with a bounce pass to Johnson. Johnson back to Enright. Enright now to Milburn. Left side dish for the three ball. It is up and good. Knocked in from the land of the trifecta by Peyton Gooden. Gooden hits the three, and Princeton is on fire now with a 7-0 run, cutting the Hardin-Central lead to 2. Along the sideline, stepping out of bounds for Hardin-Central is Addie Paul. It was right in front of Coach Hall, and now Coach Lehman has seen enough. His momentum has done a complete 180. It's gone squarely Hardin now over to Princeton. 24-22 Bulldogs, 2:10 to go in the third quarter. Timeout on the floor. We're back in 30 seconds on KGOZ.
We are Missouri Farm Bureau Insurance, and we're for road trips. We're for covering as much ground as possible on 2, 4, or 18 wheels. We're for drop tops, T-tops, classics, cruisers, pickup trucks, and dump trucks. We're for displaying Missouri plates like medals and pride. Have you ever hit a deer? Yep, we're for you too. We're for getting stuck behind a tractor on a 2-lane highway. And if you're a Missouri driver, we have an auto policy for you.
I'm Marcia Cox, your Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent. And if you're in Mercer County, I've got you covered.
Hot Country, Z101.7.
Get you a little score update here. Mizzou has opened up a 64-36 lead over Savannah State. Wes Clark, career high 22 points down in Columbia. Earlier today here from Trenton, Lafayette girls beat Kirksville 42-31. And quite the third quarter developing here. Hardin-Central scored the first 10 points of the third quarter. And now Princeton has scored the last seven. It's 24-22 Bulldogs. Princeton with it, driving through the defenders, putting up the layup and hitting is Haley Johnson. Johnson having one of the better games of her season. And there's another timeout called by Coach Kenny Lehman. He looks none too pleased after giving up the driving lane there to Haley Johnson. So another timeout called by Hardin-Central and some tough love coaching coming up from coach to players. 24-24, 1:53 to go in the third. Back in half a minute on KGLZ.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What? Are we recording a new auto shop ad?
Well, yeah, it's about time, don't you think?
True that, but the auto shop has been at 130 South Highway 65 since 2012.
Shut the front door. Jim Shaw, the best auto mechanic in the world, has been at the auto shop that long?
Yes, ma'am. Well, he's the best mechanic around my house anyway, and I wouldn't trust anyone but him and the auto shop crew under the hood of my car, and neither should you.
The auto shop, 130 South Highway 65. Give him a call today, 359-3400.
Princeton forces another turnover out of the timeout. The pass thrown into the front court. Peyton Gooden caught it in transition. The freshman lays it up and in for two. And the Tigers go to the lead at 26-24. Here with 1:19 to go in the third quarter. Princeton looked dead in the water 3 minutes ago. Now things have entirely shifted. Here's DeMint passing the ball to the right baseline to Paul. Backup jumper, no good. Weak side rebound, easy one there for the leaping Peyton Gooden. Gooden fires the ball front court to Thomas, catches the ball in traffic, put the ball on the deck, lost it, gets it back, gets the ball to the left wing to Maddie Enright. Now to the elbow, here's Milburn, jumper left of the circle is good. Savannah Milburn finds the room and cans the jumper from the left wing about 10 feet out. 28-24, Tigers on 45 seconds to go in the third. Princeton on a 13-0 run after giving up the first 10 in the quarter. A remarkable third quarter here from the Ketcham Center. Here's Paul, pass inside, knocked away by Thomas, loose on the floor, bangs to the timeline. It's grabbed there by Hardin with 28 seconds to go in the third. DeMint with the basketball for the Bulldogs, and a little bit of a brush, a screen was attempted there, but far before the screen, had some bumping and grinding against the dribble, and a foul whistled against Haley Johnson of the Tigers. That'll be her first, team's third. 28-24, Princeton led at the half, 15-14. Princeton gave up 10 in a row to fall behind by 9 to start the quarter. Now Princeton has scored 13 in a row to take the lead at 8. Pascoe's low block, turning, firing, and missing on the bank shot is Markley. Rebound to Milburn. Princeton has it. Milburn gets the ball into the hands of the double bounce. Ashley Hennis. Hennis right to left on your radio dial. Throws it away. Now they've got to break. It went right through the hands of the Hardin-Central defender. Over to Gooden, and she cans the three. Princeton cut a huge break there. That should have been a ball picked off for Hardin-Central. The Bulldogs were unable to get it. Peyton Gooden found the room, and the freshman had a big third quarter surge, pacing Princeton to a 7-point lead. It's 31-24 after three. Fourth quarter is up in a minute on KGOZ.
Right now at Kohl's and Kohl's.com, take 25% off Nike apparel, shoes, and accessories for everyone in your family during Kohl's 25% off Nike sale. Plus, everyone gets $10 Kohl's cash for every $50 spent. But hurry, Kohl's 25% off Nike sale ends Saturday. Shop now, online and in stores. Make your move, Kohl's. Select styles, promotional offers, and coupons do not apply. See store or Kohl's.com for details.
Ah, the beginning of a new year. Started off right during Rite Aid's 2016 Starting Points. Because every week through January 23rd, you can ring in the values. With 1,000 Plenty Points worth $10 in savings when you spend $30 on participating products with your Wellness Plus with Plenty card. That adds up to big savings every week for the entire month. But only at Rite Aid. With us, it's personal. Worth at least $10, limit two offers per card per week. Plenty is a rewards program. Terms and conditions apply. See plenty.com/terms for details.
Z101. 31-24, the lead for the Princeton Tigers over the Hardin-Central Bulldogs after three quarters of play. Princeton with the opening possession of the fourth quarter. Pass goes off the hands of Ashley Hennis, who had cut inside the three-point line, and the ball went back to where she was standing, off her hands and out of bounds. Hardin-Central with possession, 7:33 to go, fourth quarter. Now, the way this game is going, you expect Hardin-Central to go on maybe an 8-0 run or something of the sort. It's been that sort of game, particularly first quarter, third quarter. There's a drive all the way to the hoop. Paul goes up for the layup and draws the foul. Paul got around Hennis, late rotating there was Savannah Milburn. Got there to prevent the layup, but not the foul. Milburn called for her third personal. To the free throw line for the Bulldogs is Addie Paul. Bulldogs have had an okay game scoring the ball. I'm sure Coach Lame would say they've been a lot better, but the thing that Hardin-Central is kind of dealing with is that nobody's kind of stepping forward to be a go-to girl today. So they're getting points here and there, but they got a lot of girls who are in that 3-4-5 point category. Nobody stepped forward to say, hey, have the offense go through me. I'm going to lead us here for a while. 31-26 as Paul makes one of two, or makes two of two, I should say. 7:09 to go in the fourth. Here's Hennis, goes left side into the hands of Kylie Willett. Back to Hennis. Hennis to the right wing for Gooden. Gooden drives the ball to the right baseline, gets the ball to Milburn. Jumper from the free throw line. Back ironed it, no good. Rebound Gooden, tipped it, couldn't control it. Hardin-Central has it. Gooden awfully close to a foul, got away with one there. Dribbling away from the pressure was Addie Paul. 6:45 to go in the fourth quarter. Princeton leading 31-26. Coach Hall's gone pretty deep to the bench here. A couple of those starters are going to come back in for Princeton at the next dead ball, which is going to be right there. A pass to the baseline caught Ashton Markley flat-footed. The ball went flying out of bounds back over to the Lady Tigers as Haley Johnson and Maddie Enright, along with Vivian Allen, all check back in for Coach Wade Hall. 6:32 to go in the fourth quarter. Pass goes off to Johnson, now to the corner for Thomas. Ball knocked out of bounds by the quick hands of Kylie Manchester. So Manchester with the defensive play. It stays with Princeton. Tigers up by five. 6:25 to go in the fourth quarter. Princeton trying to get its third win of the season. Princeton boys take on Hardin-Central next. Jumper head of the key. Spins did not go in for the cold shooting Enright, but a good rebound inside. Thomas. She tries to force the layup back up and through and gets fouled as the shot came up short, but Jalen Thomas will go to the free throw line with 6:15 to go in the fourth. Free throw by Thomas is up and good, and Jalen has now hit three free throws in a row, all her points today from the charity line. Thomas with five. Second free throw for Thomas. Up spins off the rim, no good. And the rebound to Hardin-Central. Outlet pass, though, stolen by Princeton. Here's Milburn off the dish. Oh, her free throw line jumper, no good. Rebound, and the outlet pass goes from Markley into the hands of DeMint. DeMint into the front court, locks in with room. Goes right to the hoop, draws a foul, misses on the bank shot. Draws the foul with 5:59 to go in the fourth quarter. Foul's going to be whistled against Jalen Stevie Thomas. That'll be her first, team's fifth. Lacey Logsden to the free throw line for the Bulldogs. First free throw hits the front rim and bounds in. Third point to the ball game for Lacey. Second free throw coming up for Logsden. That one will rim off, and a good rebound inside. Ripping it away from the Bulldogs was Thomas. Princeton with it, up 5, 32-27, 5:50 to go in the game. Pass goes to the wing, Vivian Allen jumper, front rim no good, 16 feet away left side. Rebound, left block goes to Markley, up the near sideline, here's Logsdon. Logsdon to the free throw line. Markley now down low, Manchester drives it, baseline lost her footing, and the ball goes out of bounds, and in the process of losing her footing, Kylie Manchester called for a travel. 5:37 to go in the fourth. Princeton 32, Hardin-Central 27 in the front end of a girls-boys doubleheader on this first Saturday of 2016. Haley Johnson with the basketball launches it on top to Enright. Back to Johnson. Johnson goes baseline on the dribble. Thought she was going to get the foul, but no whistle, and she hits the jumper. Johnson fading away from the defender now has 12, and it's 34-27 Princeton. Logsdon with the ball for Hardin-Central. Fires it to the front court and fires it out of bounds. She was trying to, like you kind of would a running back in football, lead Addie Paul up the nearest sideline and catch Paul right in motion and overthrew the intended receiver by about a yard. Manchester will check out for Hardin-Central and with the basketball for Princeton. Enright, 5:05 to go in the fourth. Here's Enright to the right wing for Johnson. Back to Enright. Now to Johnson. Ball tip. Johnson has it. Fires from the right wing. Shot no good. Rebound Bulldogs. Outlet pass goes to DeMint. DeMint fires at front court, making the catch is McBee. Layup no good in transition. McBee got behind. Buttry unable to get the shot. Buttry fires the ball into the front court with the basketball. Haley Johnson. Johnson goes between the rings to Enright. Enright now left side to Allen. Back to Enright. Bounces it off to Johnson. Johnson left side Allen. Vivian Allen works to the left elbow. Swings it off to Johnson. Johnson drives. Stops. Passes to Allen. Allen gets the baseline. Goes up for the layup. Misses. Rebound Buttry. Had it. Lost it. Taken away by Julia Finley of Hardin-Central. Bulldogs down by 7 as the pass goes to Logsdon with room up the near sideline. Logsdon fires it cross court to DeMint. DeMint thought about the three, thought better of it, now gets it to Logsdon. Nice lob pass to the baseline. Bank shot no good from 4 by Finley. And on the weak side rebound, we get a foul going against Princeton. Look like inside position there for Vivian Allen, but the Princeton sophomore called for the personal foul. That'll be her second, team 6. Next one puts Hardin-Central in the bonus. Free throw off the front rim and no good for Mackenzie McBee. McBee is now 1 of 3 from the free throw line today. Second free throw for McBee. That one is up and good. McBee hits 1 of 2. She's up to 4 points in the contest. And Princeton controls a 6-point lead. Dangerous pass there, caught baseline. But then the danger in the pass was that it put Vivian Allen in a difficult position. That difficult position forces steps for the tightly guarded Allen on the near baseline. With the basketball for Hardin-Central up the near sideline, losing her footing and traveling with it is McBee. So McBee lost her footing right in front of the Hardin-Central bench. That forces steps. Ball back over to the Tigers with 3:42 to go in the fourth quarter of play. Ball goes into the right corner for Johnson. Haley Johnson now off to Enright. Enright lobbing it to Buttry and off her hands. Not a good pass, and that is a turnover against Princeton. Taken away by Hardin-Central. Here's Addie Paul. Paul gets the ball to the high post to Logsdon. Now DeMint, three ball is no good. It's spun out. Rebound to McBee, and a foul is going to be whistled against Princeton, and it'll be one in the bonus for Hardin-Central with 3:19 to go. So if Hardin-Central can knock in free throws, could be an advantage here for the team trailing as we come down the home stretch. Couple of free throws here, or at least a one in the bonus it looks like for Mackenzie McBee. Needs the first to get the second, hits the first. Big free throw make there for McBee and the Bulldogs. McBee with 5. The foul went against Vivian Allen of Princeton, her third. Team 7th. Second free throw for McBee. That one is up and good. McBee hits 2. And that closes Princeton's lead to 4. 3:15 to go. Here is Hennis with the basketball for the Tigers. Bounce pass goes to Gooden. Now to Hennis. Free throw line, Buttry. Buttry goes right of the circle. Jumper, no good. Wasn't a great shot there, but Cody got bailed out by the reach and foul against Hardin-Central. That'll put Buttrey at the free throw line, shooting two. Demintz with the foul. Her second, team six. Free throw by Cody's no good. Left that one short and right. Hit a little bit of rim, but didn't give that one a good shot at all. Second free throw coming up for Buttrey. She's yet to score today, and she'll stay that way. Second free throw off the front rim. Rebound deflects back to Buttrey. Free throw line jumper no good. So Buttrey goes 0 of 2 from the free throw line. Had a chance at the old-fashioned two-point shot, and that one came up short. 34-30, Princeton clings to a four-point lead. Under 3 minutes to go. Pass goes to the high post to Logsdon of Hardin-Central. Into the near corner. Here's Paul. Paul getting it inside. Ball stripped away and stolen by the Tigers. The steal made by Allen. Allen gets the ball to Johnson. Could make a pretty good argument that Haley has been the best player on the floor for either side today. Now she gets the ball to Hennis. Traveling called against Ashley as she worked it into the front court with 2:34 to go. That will summon Maddie Enright back into this ball game with the Tigers leading by four. For Hardin-Central, Ashlyn DeBint with the basketball. Huge possession here for the Bulldogs. Could make it a one-possession game late. 2.5 to go. Now 2:25 to go. Pass goes baseline. Nice knockaway there by Buttrey. Cody gambled on that one. Went around Finley, not knowing, but hoping she could knock that ball away on the entry pass. She did. Pass goes inside to Logsdon. Misses the layup. Coach Lehman frustrated as couldn't get the shot to go. The rebound taken by the Tigers. Here's Enright. Going right wing to Allen. Back to Enright. Enright to the left wing for Gooden. Peyton Gooden, part of a youthful Princeton core. She's a freshman. Gets the ball far sideline off the hands of Evie Allen. The sophomore gets it back in front of the timeline. Gets the ball into the hands of Enright. Enright dribbles through the double team, and we get a steal and a foul whistled against. Was it Hardin-Central? If it is, that's a tough call. Looked like Hardin-Central had the fairly clean steal. Instead, the call's going to go against Addie Paul. That'll be her second. And free throw time here for Maddie Enright of Princeton, who's had a difficult time shooting the ball today, but hasn't yet taken a free throw. Hasn't hit a shot from the field yet. Free throw here for the Princeton senior guard is good. Great sign there. Been there before. You can't seem to throw the ball in the ocean, but you get a free throw and you knock it in. Great job by Maddie Enright. Second free throw for number three. It's good. Straight butter right there for Enright. Up and down, nothing but nylon on both. 36-30. Tigers on top, 1:52 to go in the fourth quarter. Logsdon travels with it in the backcourt for Hardin-Central. And Hardin-Central seems to have five girls that can kind of handle themselves with the basketball, but they've had a couple of moments where a couple of the big girls have handled the ball in the backcourt. That's resulted in turnovers. Always is a good rule of thumb to make sure your guards are handling that rock. Princeton kind of the same way. You kind of look at Princeton and say probably three or four of the girls on the floor can kind of handle themselves as far as handling the ball, but you'd like to see Enright with the ball. Senior guard. There's a drive and a bank shot no good. Working into the front court off the pass is Hardin-Central's Ashlyn DeMint. Tried to get that ball forced inside. Finds Finley. Now to the left baseline. Here's McBee. Ball stolen away by Allen, and we're going to get a foul whistled with 1:19 to go in the fourth quarter. So Princeton really getting after it defensively, and instead of the foul, I think we're going to get a timeout that's going to go to Princeton. So before the foul, timeout given to Wade Hall. 1:19 to go in the fourth. It's Princeton 36, Hardin-Central 30. We're back in 30 seconds from the Ketcham Center in Holiday Hoops on KGOZ Sports.
Every bushel counts, and sudden death is costing farmers as much as 9 bushels per acre. That's over $75 per acre you could be losing. This is Joe Mershman. Let's get that yield back by using Allevel seed treatment from Mershman Seeds. We can add it as an option to your Mershman soybeans on those fields that have sudden death syndrome. So when the big seed companies come around, tell them thanks, but no thanks, because you've got real solutions that will make you more money from Mershman Seeds, your friend in the field.
Call Tom's Ag Spray, 875-2132.
During break, Princeton's Maddie Enright dribbled one up the far sideline, lost the ball out of bounds off her sneaker, so Hardin-Central catches a break. Bulldogs want to make this one hurt for Princeton, put the ball in the hoop. Pass goes low block into the hands of Finley, turns, fires, and misses. Rebound inside, grabbed by Logsdon, looks for position, turns, fires, hits, and draws the foul. So Lacey Logsdon, who's had a pretty rough time trying to put the ball in the hoop today, able to get that one to go, and it came at a crucial time for the Bulldogs. She gets the hoop and the harm. Foul whistle against Peyton Gooden. Her second, Logsdon's free throw. In and out, no good. The rebound to Buttrey. So Logsdon wanted the three-point play instead. Has to salvage two. Four-point lead for Princeton. 45 seconds to go. Here's Enright. Dangerous pass, and it's almost stolen away, but a foul is going to be whistled against Logsdon. Logsdon was charging hard after that basketball, which was intended on the pass for Peyton Gooden. Logsdon fouls out with 44 seconds to go. She knew it immediately. So Logsdon will end her day with 5 points. At the free throw line for Princeton, her team up by four, Maddie Enright. I beg your pardon, not Enright. It is rather Peyton Gooden at the line. Knocks it in. Good moments today for Gooden. For Haley Johnson, for Vivian Allen, some of that young core for Princeton really has shot the ball well. Second free throw, that one is off the back iron, no good. Rebound to Hardin-Central. 5-point lead for Princeton. It's go time now for the Bulldogs. 37 seconds to go, 37-32. Tigers, cross-court pass picked off by Johnson. Haley Johnson goes coast-to-coast. Layup is no good, but a foul is whistled against HC with half a minute to go. So Haley Johnson will go to the free throw line. As the foul is whistled against Kylie Manchester, her fourth. Johnson at the charity line, toss up and it rattles in. Haley Johnson now with 13 points. She has 6 in the first half, 7 in the second half. That's her first free throw attempt and first free throw make of the game. Second free throw by Haley, good, and you get the feeling that might be the knockout blow for the Tigers against the Bulldogs. Haley Johnson knocking in a pair of free throws. Princeton up 39-32 with the basketball for Hardin-Central. Here's DeMint. DeMint works up the near sideline, and we had a blocking foul whistled against Princeton's Vivian Allen. Coach Wade Hall is showing Vivian exactly why she was whistled for the foul. That'll be one part of the conversation. The other part of the conversation, if you're up 7, and there's 24 seconds left, let the girl go around you. You got teammates on the floor. We want the clock to run. Free throw by DeMint is up and good. DeMint worked just about the entire left side of that rim there. A little front, little side, little backboard before getting it up and in. Second free throw by Ashlyn. That's front iron, no good. Rebound wrestled for inside. It's tied up. Coach Lehman immediately from the Hardin-Central sideline looked at the possession arrow, and it favored his squad. So DeMint, one of two from the line, but Hardin-Central down 6 with the possession arrow. Lob pass goes baseline. Now back out for the jumper by Paul. She nails it from the right baseline. So Hardin-Central not dead yet. Addie Paul hits the 14-footer. It's 39-35. 19 seconds to go. Timeout at the Ketcham. We're back in 30 seconds on KGOZ Sports.
North Central Missouri College is proud to be a sponsor of high school athletes playing on area sports teams. As NCMC observes its 90th anniversary, we are proud of NCMC's strong legacy and continued growth. If you're thinking of returning to college, NCMC's an excellent choice. With newly expanded online degree programs and highly competitive tuition, visit ncmissouri.edu. Call 359-3948. Learn how NCMC can prepare you for the future.
Country Z101.7.
Missouri Tigers are going to the SEC next week with a 7-6 record. Missouri pounded to Savannah State. Final score just in from Mizzou Arena, 81-50. Let me send out some love to the Missouri women's basketball team. They're 13-0, ranked number 23 in the country. They start SEC play on Monday night. It should be a huge crowd for the Missouri women. The Tennessee Lady Vols are at Mizzou Arena as both squads begin SEC play. Pass is going to come inbounds. Nope, 5 second call. Princeton couldn't get it inbounds. Vivian Allen kept looking and looking, trying to give Allen the angle to get her the ball was Enright, but as the angle opened up, 5 seconds went up. Hardin-Central gets the turnover. There's a three. DeMint had her shot blocked. Loose ball grabbed by Johnson about the same time Manchester grabbed it. What was called? Johnson with the foul with 16 seconds to go. So Johnson with the personal foul, her seconds. Princeton's lead is 4. Hardin-Central golden opportunity here to make 2. It's now 3 as the first free throw is up and good for Manchester. Manchester's second free throw. Heaves it, knocks it in. Manchester hits 2. Timeout to the Bulldogs. Princeton wheezing a little bit here toward the finish. 15.9 seconds to go. It's Tigers 39, Bulldogs 37. We'll keep things right here. See what we can find on the old scoreboard for you. We pass this score along as well. If we had the ability to get downstairs and check the two earlier scores from today, we'd do that, but I don't have the ability to do that and get back up here in time. And I don't think our video man, Logan Demsich, don't think you're here early enough for Pattonsburg and Tyne Avalon, right? I don't blame you if you're not. He's kind of shaking his head. So we'll see if we can get those scores to you. If I don't get those scores and get them on the broadcast, we'll certainly have them for you later on this weekend. It was Pattonsburg and TA to start the session this morning. Princeton up by 2, running the baseline here, getting the ball inbounds to Buttery. Was Allen. Pass goes back to Vivian as she dances up the far sideline. A reach and foul is called at the timeline against Addy Paul with 9.8 seconds to go. Hardin-Central missed a golden opportunity there to foul Cody Buttery, who missed a couple of free throws earlier in this quarter. Buttery kind of more of a rebounder and grit-type player, not as much of a scorer as is Vivian Allen, but Vivian steps to the line, and the free throw comes up empty. Allen has not scored in the second half. Princeton's lead is 2. So Hardin-Central is going to have a chance to at least tie this game, maybe win it if the second free throw misses. Free throw bounces around and in. What a bounce there on the Ketcham Center rim for Vivian Allen. Down 3 are the Bulldogs. Chance to hit a 3 and send it to overtime. Working to the front court is Paul. She'll stop. She'll back up. Fires the 3 ball. No good. And Princeton will survive a late 3 attempt for Hardin-Central to win it by 3 at Holiday Hoops, 40-37. As I look down at head coach Wade Hall, big, giant, deep breath for the young Princeton coach. Happy to get that one in the W column. Pretty good comeback for Hardin-Central. One of the best shooters on the floor for the Bulldogs. Addy Paul got a look at a good 3 from the head of the key. Couldn't knock it in, and Princeton survives. 40-37, the final score in the front end of our girls-boys doubleheader on Z101.7 and KGOZ-TV. Stay tuned for the scoring summary. It's up in 2 minutes as the Lady Tigers win it on Hot Country Z101.7.
Facing tough family choices about caring for your parent? Choose Servlink Home Care's aides and nurses for quality care at home. Need physical therapy to rehab an injury or surgery? Get better and get stronger at home. How about safety when you can't be there? Lifeline is there 24/7 with help at the touch of a button. Call Servlink today at 359-4218. We help people live safely at home. Servlink Home Care, providing the simple pleasures of home since 1973.
Big G Foodland in Princeton is a longtime proud supporter of their hometown Princeton Tigers. For tailgating before the next Tiger game, swing by Big G, always featuring great deals on your favorites, like ribs and beef. Visit BigGFoodland.com to see the latest ad special, recipes, and ways to eat smarter and healthier. Big G Foodland, conveniently located at 107 North Washington Street in Princeton, says go Tigers!
Right now at Kohl's and Kohl's.com, take 25% off Nike apparel, shoes, and accessories for everyone in your family during Kohl's 25% off Nike sale. Plus, everyone gets $10 Kohl's cash for every $50 spent. But hurry, Kohl's 25% off Nike sale ends Saturday. Shop now, online and in stores. Make your move, Kohl's. Select styles, promotional offers, and coupons do not apply. See store or Kohl's.com for details.
Ah, the beginning of a new year. Started off right during Rite Aid's 2016 Starting Points. Because every week through January 23rd, you can ring in the values. With 1,000 plenty points worth $10 in savings when you spend $30 on participating products with your Wellness Plus with Plenty card. That adds up to big savings every week for the entire month. But only at Rite Aid. With us, it's personal. Worth at least $10 from the two offers per card per week. Plenty is a rewards program. Terms and conditions apply. See plenty.com/terms for details.
I know a place where the grass is really greener.
Hot Country Z101.7.
Here's the scoring summary. Kind of working on it here as we get things back from a break from our KGLZ studios in downtown Trenton. Nobody in double figures for Hardin-Central. Let's go to Princeton and see what adds up there. I know we've got a couple for Princeton, at least Haley Johnson for one in double figures. And it looks like that's going to be it in the double figures total for Princeton. So Princeton gets the victory, 40-37 over Hardin-Central. Scoring summary looks like this for Princeton. Haley Johnson with 14 points, 9 in the contest from Peyton Gooden, 8 for Vivian Allen, 5 for Jalen Thomas, 2 for Savannah Milburn, and 2 points for Maddie Enright. Princeton will be at Maysville next Friday night. It'll be a girls-boys doubleheader that you can hear on KTTN-FM 92.3 between the Tigers and the Wolverines. I believe, don't quote me on it, but I believe this is true. First Grand River Conference matchups of the season for Princeton will be at Maysville in 6 nights on KTTN. Look like I'll be over at Maysville for those broadcasts next Friday. Hardin-Central came up just a little bit short. Topsy-turvy ball game. Let me do some addition here on the final totals as far as the fourth quarter scoring goes. That'll kind of add a little bit of clarity to what we'll talk about here. Hardin-Central outscored Princeton 7-4 in the first quarter. Princeton came back strong, outscored Hardin 11-7 in the second quarter. Third quarter, 16-10. Princeton sounded like Princeton got the better of Hardin-Central, right? That's only half the story. Hardin-Central scored the first 10 points of the third quarter, and Princeton scored the final 16 points of the quarter. Actually, let me add that up again. 4, 8. That was 16. Seemed like that was a little bit high, but we'll go with that. 16-10. Princeton outscored Hardin-Central in the third. Princeton generally did a good job in the fourth quarter, but as so often happens in these high school games, especially a little bit inexperienced, and Princeton is a little bit inexperienced, you can find a way to win, but sometimes it's tough to close people out. Princeton's still kind of learning how to close people out. That almost bit the Lady Tigers, and they survived. 1-3, a late three-pointer by Addie Paul, Hardin-Central. Got a good look about 20 feet away, and it had about 19.5 feet of distance. Just barely scraped the front rim. So Princeton gets the victory. Hardin-Central outscored Princeton in the fourth quarter to the tune of 13-9. So again for Princeton, Haley Johnson, 14. Peyton Gooden, 9. Vivian Allen, 8. Jalen Stevie Thomas with 5. Savannah Milburn with 2. And Maddie Enright with 2. For Hardin-Central today, Ashlyn DeMint had 9 points. Mackenzie McBee with 8. Julia Finley with 8. 6 for Addie Paul. 5 points for Lacey Logsden, 3 points for Kylie Manchester. The Princeton boys and the Hardin-Central boys warming up right now. We're about 5 minutes away from the opening tip. So we'll go 4 minutes on this break, and we'll have the Tigers and the Bulldogs on the boys' side coming up next on Hot Country Z101.7 and KGOZ-TV. Final score from Mizzou Arena. The Mizzou men beat Savannah State earlier today, 81-50. Wes Clark, 22 points. Name on right, 11 for the Tigers of Old Mizzou. We're back in 4 minutes with Tiger Boys Basketball on KGOZ-TV.
The Princeton School District Administration, faculty, and staff all give a collective salute to the young men and women competing on the various Tiger sports teams. You've put forth the extra hours and practices before the games and maintain a busy classroom and extracurricular schedule. Good luck to the Princeton Tigers. Do your best in athletics and academics. Tiger Nation is proud of all the Princeton students, athletes, their coaches, fans, and supporters. Princeton, our 5 school.
We are Missouri Farm Bureau Insurance, and we're for the people of Missouri. We're for kayakers, car dealers, grocery baggers, and mail carriers. We're for teachers, preachers, students, and singers. Armed service members, you bet we're for you. We're for people who shake your hand and say hello, not because they know you, but because they don't. We're for brewmasters, stockbrokers, beauty queens, and truck drivers. And don't worry, we're still for farmers, too. Whatever you do, if you're a Missourian, we're for you.
I'm Marcia Cox, your Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent. And if you're in Mercer County,
Ralph and Chillicothe, checking out that KGOZ forecast again for you. Brought to you by McDonald's. You can get a soft drink inside, soft drink for $1. It's at McDonald's. I'm loving it. For tonight, clear skies, lows down to 18 degrees. Sunny skies tomorrow, highs near 29 degrees. Partly cloudy for tomorrow night, looking for lows down around 14. Mostly sunny skies on your Monday. Highs near 28, looking at your Monday night, mostly clear skies. 16 degrees. Tuesday says mostly sunny skies, highs near 34, partly cloudy Tuesday night, lows down around 22 degrees. Looking at your Wednesday forecast for hump day, partly sunny skies, highs near 36, mostly cloudy for Wednesday night, lows down.
Completely different ball team if they have the big 6'10 center in there. Princeton very young in the backcourt, but if they have that rock inside and that solid anchor in Stephen Elliott, it makes Princeton that much better. It makes, instead of kind of being the number one go-to guy, starting at forward is number 33, Ryler. Starting at forward, number 40, Tommy Burton. Again, Coach Kenny Lehman and Assistant Tom Twyman of the Hardin-Central Bulldogs start Gorham and Lehman in the backcourt. Kugler, Estenbaum, and Burton along the front line. For the Princeton Tigers, first-year head coach up at PHS is Mike Creekmore, assisted by Tyson Miller. The Tigers will start at the guards. Pair of freshmen in number 12, Cameron Jones, and number 13, Logan Duncan. Front line made up of small forward, probably more guard ability than forward ability, but we'll give them the three position, the small forward start, and Calvin Berwanger. Starting at center is number 23, Hunter Boxley, and starting at the power forward is number 24, Blaine Milburn. Princeton will be in on the bottom of the short. So sharp looking for Princeton as always with that blue and white. They take on the black and orange of Hardin-Central. Opening tip coming up. It'll be Boxley jumping it up against Kugler. The opening tip won by Kugler. He quick jumped Boxley. Pass into the front court, knocked away, and Boxley gets it back for Princeton. Tigers with it off the quick turnover, going from left to right on your dial. Going right down the heart of the paint for the Tigers. Putting up the shot and missing is Cameron Jones. Might have been blocked on the way up on the rebound. Or loose ball taken by HC's Ryan Lehman. Lehman into the front court for the Bulldogs. Veers off right side. Pick and roll. The ball swatted away by Boxley. Boxley gets it into the front court to Duncan. Duncan weaves through. Defenders goes to the right wing. Gets the ball to Jones. Now left side to Milburn. Lobs it toward Boxley. Ball knocked away. Good defense there by Hardin-Central. Cliff Kugler able to tip that ball and start a little volleyball match. It ends up in the hands of the Bulldogs, and here is Lehman. Lehman to the right wing for Gorham. Now Gorham off to the left side to Burton. Burton with it. Fires it into the left corner for Lehman. Lehman inside, leaping, unable to make the catch. Cliff Kugler. Ball's a little bit high, and maybe more so it was thrown early. The timing of the play was off just a touch. No score, a minute deep into the first half. Both teams might be dealing with a little bit of post-Christmas, post-New Year's ruggedness. Here's Milburn, pass the ball baseline to Jones, now to Boxley. Ball knocked away and kicked out of bounds by the Bulldogs. It'll stay with Princeton with 6:51 to go in the first quarter. Logan Duncan to toss the ball in from the right baseline. 2 weeks ago in a loss here at Holiday Hoops, Duncan had a career-high 19. Princeton fell to Linn County. Very good Linn County team. Back on the 19th. With the ball for the Tigers is Berwanger to the right wing. Now inside, ball bobbled by Milburn. Has it left right wing. Shot no good. Good defense on the play as Lehman gets the rebound off the front iron. Lehman with it for the Bulldogs. Pull up three from the wing. Missed it off the back iron. The rebound of the Tigers. Ball lost right back to Lehman. Unable to reel that one in is Milburn. Lehman gets the ball off left side to Estenbaum. Now back to Lehman. Gets the high screen. Goes left to the circle. Picks up the dribble and goes off to Burton. Burton in front of the anchor logo to Riley Gorham. Gorham goes to the left wing to Lehman. Lehman now down the heart of the paint, making the catch and wrapping the pass around was Cliff Kugler. And that pass inside the paint knocked away by Princeton. Racing into the front court for the Tigers is Calvin Berwanger. Berwanger gets the ball off to Blaine Milburn. Milburn to the head of the key to the free throw line. Passes off to Boxley. Head and shoulder fake Boxley through it to no man's land. It's chased down far sideline by Milburn. Milburn passes it off to Duncan, now Jones. Jones to Boxley, who flashes to the head of the key. Bounce pass goes to Milburn. Milburn fading out to the left side. Goes on top on the bounce to Berwanger. Berwanger drives it baseline, and as he set up for a shot, he lost the ball and gets called for a travel. So no score, 2.5 minutes in. Team's trying to work off some New Year's turkey, it appears, as we go to a timeout here at the Ketcham Center. No score between the Tigers and Bulldogs here on KGOZ-TV. We're back in 30 seconds.
We just found out about this great business that provides home health care located in Trenton. It's called Surflink Home Care.
What do you mean you just found out? They've been here 40 years.
But I never needed them, so I never noticed them. Now with Mom ill and Dad getting a joint replacement, I need them. They have great nurses, therapists, and aides, and work with our doctors to provide excellent care at home.
Aren't they in the old ice house on 9th Street?
Yep, I called them, 359-4218. It's hard taking care of your parents' home care needs, but Surflink makes it really simple. Give them a call, 359-4218.
My party station.
Hot Country Z101.
No score, 5:20 to go in the first quarter between Hardin-Central and Princeton. With the basketball for Hardin-Central, Riley Gorham. Toss the ball along the far sideline, is tipped by the Tigers and taken by Hardin-Central's Lehman. Got tripped up, nothing called. Picks the ball up in the corner. Rock'em Sock'em Robot basketball here as the pass goes to the free throw line to Burton. Back to Lehman inside, and a push is whistled against Boxley. Boxley was kind of getting shoved there right underneath the hoop, trying to keep Cliff Kugler away from a scoring opportunity. Hunter called for his first foul, team foul number one. Pass goes right of the circle for Burton. Burton to Lehman, down low to Kugler against the double team. Nice pass to the left block, and a layup is missed by Estenbaum. He tipped the ball into the corner over to the Tigers. So his best chance to score right there. The excellent pass through the double team. That's one where you have a shot, but you find somebody for a better shot, and the better shot missed. So no score, 3 minutes and 15 seconds into the first quarter. Here's Boxley with the ball for Princeton. Throws the ball to the wing. It's loose, almost stolen away. Quick hands got that away from Cameron Jones with the loose ball. Here's Logan Duncan. Lobs it into the hands of Berwanger. Goes down the heart of the paint. Traveling called against Calvin with 4:28 to go in the first quarter. Andrew Smith will check in for Princeton, replacing Hunter Boxley. With the basketball for Hardin-Central, Ryan Lehman. Lehman from right to left on the dial, moves left side and throws the ball away. Threw it right to Calvin Berwanger, fires it to the front court. Here's Jones, driving, shooting, and scoring. Cameron Jones with the bucket, and the Tigers jump out on top after the unforced turnover against the Bulldogs. Timeout's going to go here to Coach Lehman. He's irritated by the level play of his guys. 4:08 to go in the first quarter. It's Princeton 2, Hardin-Central no score. We're back in 30 seconds on KGLZ 101.7.
Ribs and beef. Visit BigGFoodLand.com. Gas special, recipes, and ways to eat smarter and healthier. Big G Foodland, conveniently located at 107 North Washington Street in Princeton, says go Tigers.
Z101.7. Out of the timeout, Blaine Milburn picks the pocket of a Hardin-Central player at the timeline, glides in coast to coast, and hits the layup. It's 4-0 Princeton. 3:45 to go in the second quarter. So both teams kind of stuck in neutral for the first 4 minutes of the ball game. Now Princeton has used its defense Back-to-back steals turning into back-to-back layups. Hardin-Central still with that goose egg on the board as Kugler tried to fire the baseline pass, and it went wide of the intended target. Esten Baum and out of bounds. 3.5 to go in the first quarter. Princeton 4, Hardin-Central nothing. With the basketball for the Tigers, Logan Duncan. Duncan works to the high free throw line. Down the paint he goes. Splits the defense. Puts up the shot. Misses and draws the foul with 3:19 to go in the first quarter. Riley Gorham of Hardin-Central will be called for the foul. His first, team's first. There have been many occasions in this shootout because you get teams playing for whatever reason. I don't know why this would be the case, but it happens. You get them playing on A, it's a Saturday. B, it's not a school day. It's a lengthy road trip for Hardin-Central, and you just look flat. Hardin-Central looks flat. Both free throws missed by Duncan. Rebound to Hardin-Central. Bulldogs 3:13 to go in the first quarter. Still scoreless. 4-0. Princeton on top. Three ball by Lehman. Drilled it. Rattled it in from the head of the key. Surprised that Princeton would give Lehman that good of a look. They did, and they paid for it. 4-3. Tigers lead down to 1. With the basketball for the Tigers, Duncan sprints with it. Right side now lobs the ball after the circle for Andrew Smith. Smith goes into the corner. Now back to Duncan. Bounces it on top to Jones. 2:45 to go in the opening quarter. Jones gets the ball to Smith. Now left side to Milburn. Milburn to the head of the key to Berwanger. Berwanger to the right wing. The dish goes off to Duncan. Duncan with the basketball for Big Blue goes on top to Smith. Andrew Smith left side now to Jones. Jones to the baseline making the catch. There's Berwanger. Spins inside the paint. Puts up the bank shot. Misses. Rebound to Smith. Puts it back up. Off the iron. No good. Rebound tussled for and grabbed by Riley Gorham of Hardin-Central. He dribbles to just find a little bit of breathing room. Finds it. Now finds his point guard in Ryan Lehman. Lehman gets the screen from the right wing. Takes the ball baseline. Gets the baseline. Hangs. Shoots and misses. Got his own rebound. Puts it up and misses. Rebound tussled for inside. Is going to be kicked to the elbow. Grabbed there by the Tigers. Still loose and grabbed off the deflection by Lehman. Lehman backs up and fires the three ball. Missed. Rebound Bulldogs. Hardin-Central a bit more active now on the floor as Gorham gets the ball baseline. Lehman the catch. The shot. It's no good. Foul whistled against Princeton's Blaine Milburn. Will put Ryan Lehman at the free throw line to shoot two with 1:49 to go in the opening quarter. 14, so Blaine Milburn called for his first personal. It's team foul number two against the Tigers. Ryan Lehman's free throw is good, and we're tied at four. As Lehman goes on a quick 4-0 spurt for the visitors out of Hardin-Central. Second free throw. That spins out. Rebound of the Tigers. Pulling it down was Blaine Milburn. A foul whistled against Hardin-Central. Ryler Estenbaum called for the personal. His first, team's second. So Princeton from left to right on your radio dial into the front court. Here's Cameron Jones. Jones fires the ball off right side to Logan Duncan. Duncan picks up the dribble. We'll go left side now into the hands of Milburn. Milburn off to Smith. Smith throws it baseline to Berwanger. Berwanger gets it off to Smith. Smith's pass kicks, and that'll keep it with Princeton with 1:27 to go in the first quarter. Matthew Burton in for Hardin-Central. And checking in for Princeton will be Cody Kelly, number 20. Kelly replacing Andrew Smith. 4-4 your score. Tigers locked up in a low-scoring duel with the Bulldogs early in this contest. Here's Jones to Duncan. Duncan back to Jones. Lobs it inside. Nice entry pass, but it went right through the hands of Berwanger and deflects over to Lehman of the Bulldogs. Right to left on your dial is Ryan Lehman of Hardin-Central. Works against Milburn. Gets a screen. Takes the ball to left wing. Goes on top to Gorham. Back to Lehman. Lehman fakes the three. Takes the ball baseline. Hangs. Shoots. Misses. Weak side rebound put up and missed on the shot there by Cliff Kugler, but getting the ball back and putting it back up and in is Ryan Lehman. Lehman has all six Hardin-Central points, and it's 6-4 Bulldogs with 45 seconds to go in the quarter. Driving down the paint is Duncan. Hangs, shoots, and misses on the shot. Kugler with the rebound, fires the outlet pass to Gorham, and Gorham gets the ball to Lehman. Lehman with it for Hardin-Central with 31 seconds to go in the first quarter. Lehman from the right wing goes baseline. That pass chases Kugler in the corner. Gets it back to Lehman along the sideline. Lehman drifts to the corner. Now fakes the three. Nice dish inside. The catch and the jumper's spun up and good by Ryler Estenbaum. Estenbaum with the bucket makes it 8-4. Hardin-Central with 12 seconds to go in the opening quarter of play. With the basketball for Princeton is Cameron Jones. Jones will dribble it into the teeth of the defense. Swings the pass into the corner. Berwanger's three ball is long, no good. Rebound grabbed at the horn by Hardin-Central. And the Bulldogs, after a very slow start, end the quarter on an 8-0 run. It's Hardin-Central 8, Princeton 4. We're back to the Ketcham Center with second quarter action in a minute on KGLZ-TV.
We are Missouri Farm Bureau Insurance, and we're for home sweet home. We're for condos, tutors, single wides, and studios. We're for ranches, houseboats, two stories or 20. Red cedar, bluebird, white spruce, black walnuts, whatever's out your back door, we're for that. We're for watching the sun rise over the Mississippi and set over the Missouri. We're for kicking off your heels in a high rise or hanging up your hat in the bootio. And if you have a home in Missouri, we have a policy for you.
I'm Marcia Cox, your Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent. And if you're in Mercer County, I've got you covered.
Whoa. What? Are we recording a new auto shop ad?
Well, yeah, it's about time, don't you think?
True that, but the auto shop has been at 130 South Highway 65 since 2012.
Shut the front door. Jim Shaw, the best auto mechanic in the world, has been at the auto shop that long?
Yes, ma'am. Well, he's the best mechanic around my house anyway, and I wouldn't trust anyone but him and the auto shop crew under the hood of my car, and neither should you.
The auto shop, 130 South Highway 65. Give him a call today, 359-3400.
Hot Country, Z101.7.
Milburn has the ball inside the free throw line for Princeton. His shot starts second quarter is blocked on the way up. Hardin-Central with the possession. Here's Lehman getting a screen, taking the ball to the left baseline. Jumper, no good. Weak side rebound taken off the deflection by Princeton. Ball flung into the front court. It goes from Duncan to Jones. Jones lost it. Chase it down near sideline. Now comes to the anchor. Center court, Ketcham Center resets the offense. He'll go to Duncan from the right side. Duncan works it to the elbow, spins and swings it on top into the hands of Kelly. Now Kelly left side to Milburn. Milburn to Berwanger. Berwanger to the right wing for Jones. Jones from the wing to the free throw line, swings it back outside the arc to Duncan, and Duncan goes off to Milburn. Milburn with the basketball for the Tigers. Goes left side to Jones. Jones now to Berwanger. Right wing Duncan to Jones. Jones to Kelly, now to Milburn. Milburn from the left wing for Princeton. Off that motion, offense goes to Jones. He'll toss it to the high post, into the hands of Berwanger. Now left side to Milburn. Milburn fakes the three. Dishes it on top to Kelly. Kelly to the wing for Duncan. Logan Duncan thought about the dribble now. Takes a couple of them and goes to the head of the key for Jones. Jones off to Berwanger. And Berwanger will give the ball off to Duncan. Duncan works the ball to the elbow, swings it into the corner. Three ball by Milburn is good. Blaine Milburn with his second bucket of the ball game. It's a three, and that cuts Hardin-Central's lead to one. It's Bulldogs 8, Tigers 7, with 6:18 to go in the second quarter of play. With the basketball for Hardin-Central, Ryan Lehman gets that screen, takes the ball to the left corner. Here's Lehman going underneath to Kugler. Kugler tried to power that shot up through the Princeton defense. And draws the foul against the Tigers with 6:08 to go in the second quarter. So Kugler to the free throw line. Foul whistle against Calvin Berwanger. His first free throw by Kugler spins in. So Cliff Kugler gets Hardin-Central on the board here in the second quarter. It's Bulldogs 9, Tigers 7. Princeton won the girls' contest between these schools 40-37. Second free throw for Kugler. He fires and connects. Kugler hits a pair. And it's 10-7, Hardin-Central. With the basketball for Big Blue, it's Cameron Jones. From left to right on the dial, Jones beats his defender, goes down the paint, lost the ball, and he went up and down with it. That'll be a traveling called against Cameron Jones. Went up with the ball, landed with the ball. 5:55 to go in the first half. Hardin-Central leading Princeton 10-7. Lehman crosses over Milburn, works to the elbow. Pass goes off to Burton. Now to Lehman. Lehman inside to Kugler. Catches it baseline, and that'll be a foul whistled against Princeton's Cody Kelly. Kelly is trying to keep Kugler from a layup, and Kugler was just starting to use that muscle to go baseline to get a layup opportunity. So Kelly forced a foul there. That'll be Cody's first. Pass goes right inside to Lehman. He catches, shoots, and he banks it in. Lehman got open behind the Princeton defense baseline. Makes it 12-7 Hardin-Central with 5.5 to go in the second quarter. With the basketball for Princeton, Cameron Jones. Jones goes off to Milburn. Milburn from the left wing. Now head of the key to Berwanger to the right wing for Duncan. Duncan flashes it on top to Kelly. Kelly goes left of the key for Jones. Jones off to Milburn. He throws the ball away. Ball loose in the paint. Stolen by Hardin-Central. Kugler has it. He finds Burton. And Burton hands the ball off. Into the front court comes Ryan Lehman. Lehman goes left side. Drives baseline. Fades. Shoots. Misses. Weak side rebound. Bulldogs. With it for Hardin-Central. Estenbaum. Gets it right back. Now back out to the wing, and traveling is going to be called against Riley Gorham. He's doing a little bit too much dancing, didn't have those feet set. So Gorham called for his taps as Boxley checks in for Kelly for the Princeton boys. 4:49 to go in the first half. It's Hardin-Central 12 and Princeton 7 here on KGOZ and KGOZ TV. Check out YouTube.com, search for KTTN Radio, and look for the live broadcast for Princeton Hardin-Central boys. Here's Milburn. Drives to the free throw line. Almost ran into his own teammate in Berwanger. Hands the ball off to Berwanger. Now to Boxley. Boxley gets the ball to Jones. Jones being pressured tightly by Lehman. Jones gives the ball off to Duncan. Duncan tries a dipsy-doo move there. That didn't work. So he gives the ball off to Boxley. Now Boxley off to Jones. Jones goes to Duncan. Duncan from the right wing. Hardin-Central locked in defensively here in the second quarter. Princeton's doing a lot of dribbling, a lot of passing without getting a lot done. 4 minutes to go in the half. Pass goes to Boxley. Boxley from the right wing. Swings it on top for Duncan. Duncan works it to the elbow, and he draws a reach and foul. That was not a bad foul against Hardin-Central's Tommy Burton. Not for that, Duncan would have had himself a layup. So Burton gets called for the reach. That'll be his first foul, team foul number 3 against Hardin-Central. 3:56 to go in the first half. Princeton down 5. Pass goes to the low block to Milburn. Catches, shoots, and the hanger is good over the sea of arms. Couple of arms up in the air there for Hardin-Central. Neither either to get the block. Blaine Milburn has 7, and it's 12-9. Hardin-Central with the basketball for the Bulldogs. Taking it left side as Lehman goes baseline. Fires it to the block to Kugler. Catches, shoots, scores. Cliff Kugler with the bucket makes it 14-9, 3:30 to go in the first half. With the basketball for Princeton, Cameron Jones. Jones off to Logan Duncan. Duncan to Boxley, back to Duncan, left side. Milburn thought about the three, thought better of it, dribbles it to the elbow, goes on top for Jones. Cameron with jab step, now steps back, goes left side to Boxley. Jumper by Hunter's good. 16 feet away, left side. Hunter Boxley gets his first bucket of the ball game and makes it 14-11 in favor of Hardin-Central. 3 minutes to go in half number one. With the basketball is Ryan Lehman of the Bulldogs wearing the black and orange. Long three ball, left side, banks it in. Saturday Bank Open in downtown Trenton as Ryan Lehman hits the three, and it's 17-11. With the basketball for the blue and white is Cameron Jones. Jones gets a screen from Boxley. Takes the ball to the right wing. Passes it off to Milburn. Milburn leaves it to Jones. Jones now to Duncan. Logan Duncan back to Cameron Jones. Jones with the basketball for the Tigers goes right side to Boxley. Boxley to Milburn. Milburn with it works to the three-point arc and gives the ball off to Duncan. Duncan to Berwanger, steps inside the defender, misses the layup, and the rebound to Kugler. Kugler will hand the basketball off to Ryan Lehman. Lehman with a game-high 11 points for Hardin-Central. His team up by 6. Works it to the right wing with 2 minutes to go in the half. Pass almost stolen away. It found Kugler. Now back to Lehman. Lehman fakes the three. Passes to Kugler. Kugler's cross-court pass picked off inside the paint by Princeton. Logan Duncan races the other way. Around 1, around 2, around 3. Hang, shoots, misses. Rebound to Berwanger. Gets it out to Jones. 3 ball by Cameron's no good. Rebound to Boxley. And he's pushed and fouled with 1:37 to go in the second quarter. Cliff Kugler called for the personal foul. That'll be his first, team's fourth. Toss in here from the right baseline for the Tigers and Cameron Jones. Jones will lob it toward the timeline. Chasing it down there will be Berwanger. Calvin says, teammates, come help me out. Somebody give me a passing lane. Helping him out is Milburn. Hits the ball to Boxley. Boxley to Jones. Jones from the head of the key. Now off into the hands of Berwanger. Berwanger puts the ball on the deck. He spins. He fakes. Fakes again. Passes it off to Duncan. Shot from the left block. No good. And the rebound claimed by Hardin-Central. Kugler gets the pass into the hands of Lehman. Fires it inside. Ball loose. Should have been caught there for a layup, but unable to bring it in was Burton. And the ball taken away by Princeton. Boxley gets the ball front court. Now lobs inside to Berwanger. His layup is good off the lob pass from Milburn. Calvin Berwanger with his first bucket of the ball game makes it 17-13, Hardin-Central. 50 seconds left to go in the second quarter. Lehman steps into the front court for the Bulldogs. He'll take that left side wing. Backs up, now fires a shot. Not a good shot there by Lehman. Got bailed out on the weak side rebound by Kugler. Gets it on to the free throw line to Burton. Burton off to Gorham. Gorham to the right wing to Lehman. Lehman inside, working for position, putting up the shot and missing badly was Kugler. And on the rebound, a foul is going to be whistled against Riley Gorham of Hardin-Central. He was over the back. They call that against Cliff Kugler. That'll be his second foul and team foul number five with 28 seconds left to go in the second quarter. It's Hardin-Central 17, Princeton 13. With the basketball for the Tigers, Calvin Berwanger. Berwanger goes to the right wing with the possession, guarded loosely here by Ryler Estenbaum. Berwanger steps inside the three-point arc, almost lost his footing, kept the footing going, shoots it from the left wing, banks it in for two. Calvin Berwanger with a bank shot from 16 feet away left side, and that will cut the Hardin-Central lead to two at the end of one half of play. Calvin Berwanger, a couple of late buckets for Princeton, and at the half, it's the Hardin-Central Bulldogs 17 and the Princeton Tigers 15. We'll have the halftime scoring summary coming up in 2 minutes. You're watching the Princeton Tigers live on KGOZ-TV and Hot Country Z101.7.
More commodity prices are making it difficult to make a profit. Looking at the markets, they've dropped almost half. You're thinking, I need to cut costs. The fastest way to lower your profit is more yield. Hi, this is what are the biggest factors that will affect your yield next year on your farm? Weeds? Sudden death? Mercer Seeds has the best solutions for your farm's yield. You've been through this before, and you'll get through it again today.
Call Tom Spray at 75-2132.
Facing tough family choices about caring for your parents?
Choose Serving Hospitals, aides, and nurses for quality care. Need physical therapy to rehab an injury or surgery? Get better and get stronger at home. How about safety when you can't be there? Lifeline is there 24/7 with help at the touch of a button. Call Serving today at 359-4218. We help people live safely at home. Serving Home Care, providing the simple pleasures of home since 1973.
Right now at Kohl's and Kohl's.com, take 25% off Nike apparel, shoes, and accessories for everyone in your family during Kohl's 25% off Nike sale. Plus, everyone gets $10 Kohl's cash for every $50 spent. But hurry, Kohl's 25% off Nike sale ends Saturday. Shop now, online, and in stores. Make your move. Kohl's. Select styles, promotional offers, and coupons do not apply. See store or Kohl's.com for details.
Ah, the beginning of a new year. Started off right during Rite Aid's 2016 Starting Points. Because every week through January 23rd, you can ring in the values. With 1,000 Plenty Points worth $10 in savings when you spend $30 on participating products with your Wellness Plus with Plenty card. That adds up to big savings every week for the entire month. But only at Rite Aid. With us, it's personal. Worth at least $10 through two offers per card per week. Plenty is a rewards program. Terms and conditions apply. See plenty.com/terms for details.
Coming up next week, big doubleheader from Ludlow on Tuesday night. It'll be Mercer at Southwest Livingston. Girls game at 6, boys game 7:30. We'll have exclusive radio coverage on KTTN-FM 92.3 and on TuneIn Radio. Search KTTN. Get all your audio coverage. Big girls ball game. Southwest lost a couple of ball games since getting that number four rating, so they probably won't be rated there next week, but still a very good basketball team. Southwest Livingston made the Final Four last year. Mercer made the Elite Eight. They'll go head-to-head at 6 with the boys game to follow at 7:30. Mercer at Southwest Livingston Tuesday. KTTN will have a North Central Missouri College Lady Pirate basketball at Kansas City, Kansas. That will be on Wednesday at 5 o'clock. I can't remember off the top of my head which one it is, but it'll be kind of in that general area. With NCMC at KCK Women's Basketball Wednesday on Hot Country Z101.7. Wall-to-wall basketball. Then next Friday we will have Trenton at Brookfield on Hot Country Z101.7. We'll have Dennis Stevenson on that play-by-play call. And we'll have these Princeton Tigers at Maysville Friday night. KTTN-FM 92.3. The girls game at 6. Boys game at 7:30. And we'll have a fair share of Mizzou basketball sprinkled in there as well. Maybe the big game of the week. Not going to be available on the network, but it's going to be a big one. The Mizzou women unbeaten, ranked number 23. They will host the Tennessee Lady Vols on Monday night. The Mizzou men open SEC play at Georgia on Wednesday. 5 o'clock for pregame from Athens on KTTN-FM. And the Missouri women will be, Georgia for the Missouri women on Thursday. We'll have that game available on KTTN-FM 92.3. Will the Mizzou women be unbeaten when they play Georgia on Thursday night? Have to go through that always tough Tennessee Lady Vol team Monday in Columbia in order to find that out. Undoubtedly, that'll be the biggest women's game that program has seen in many, many years. Maybe the biggest game in program history as far as hype-wise. They're really getting fired up for that Lady Vols Tigers game Monday night in Columbia. 17-15 the score here. It was 8-4 Hardin-Central after one quarter. Both teams scored 11 points in the second quarter. Ryan Lehman led Hardin-Central with 11 first-half points. Cliff Kugler had 4 and Ryler Estenbaum 2. Princeton had more balanced scoring, led by Blaine Milburn with 7. 4 points for Calvin Berwanger. 2 for Hunter Boxley and 2 for Cameron Jones. Suited up today but not yet seeing action is Stephen Elliott. Seems that he gets closer to action, but still has been on that suspension. So Coach Creekmore not yet letting off the reins of the suspension there for Stephen Elliott, who is in uniform today. Haven't seen the big junior center as of yet for the Tigers. 17-15, it's the lead for Hardin-Central over Princeton at the break. We'll take that 4-minute timeout. Third quarter action comes your way next here on KGOZ-TV. And KGOZ on TuneIn Radio, along with local radio, Hot Country Z101.7. We're back in 4.
Big G Foodland in Princeton is a longtime proud supporter of their hometown Princeton Tigers. For tailgating before the next Tiger game, swing by Big G, always featuring great deals on your favorites, like ribs and beef. Visit BigGFoodland.com to see the latest ad specials, recipes, and ways to eat smarter and healthier. Big G Foodland, conveniently located at 107 North Washington Street in Princeton, says go Tigers!
North Central Missouri College is proud to be a sponsor of high school athletes playing on area sports teams. As NCMC observes its 90th anniversary, we are proud of NCMC's strong legacy and continued growth. If you're thinking of returning to college, NCMC is an excellent choice with newly expanded online degree programs and highly competitive tuition. Visit ncmissouri.edu. Call 359-3948. Learn how NCMC can prepare you for the future.
Right now at Kohl's and Kohl's.com, take 25% off Nike apparel, shoes, and accessories for everyone in your family during Kohl's 25% off Nike sale. Plus, everyone gets $10 Kohl's cash for every $50 spent. But hurry, Kohl's 25% off Nike sale ends Saturday. Shop now, online, and in stores. Make your move. Kohl's. Select styles, promotional offers, and coupons do not apply. See store or Kohl's.com for details.
You could spend a dollar in that app on your phone, buy yourself some digital gold coins,
Although converting actual money into imaginary money isn't the shrewdest investment strategy. Maybe get a Crunchwrap slider at Taco Bell instead. Four delicious flavors like Sriracha Chicken and Spicy Beefy Nacho for just $1 each. They're real and real delicious. Crunchwrap sliders for $1, only at Taco Bell. At participating locations for a limited time, prices may vary, tax extra.
We are Missouri Farm Bureau Insurance, and we're for the people of Missouri. We're for kayakers, car dealers, grocery baggers, and mail carriers. We're for teachers, preachers, students, and singers. Armed service members, you bet we're for you. We're for people who shake your hand and say hello, not because they know you, but because they don't. We're for brewmasters, stockbrokers, beauty queens, and truck drivers. And don't worry, we're still for farmers too. Whatever you do, if you're a Missourian, we're for you.
I'm Marcia Cox, your Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent. And if you're in Mercer County, I've got you covered.
Checking that KGOZ forecast out for tonight, brought to you by McDonald's. That's McDonald's. I'm loving it. For tonight, clear skies, lows down around 18 degrees. Sunny for tomorrow, highs near 29. Looking at tomorrow night, partly cloudy skies, lows down to 14. Looking at your Monday forecast, sunny skies, highs near 28 degrees. Looking at Monday night, mostly clear skies, lows down to 16. Sunny for your Tuesday, highs near 34 degrees. Looking at Tuesday night, partly cloudy, lows down to 22. Partly sunny for your hump day Wednesday, highs to be near 36. Mostly cloudy for Wednesday night, lows down around 28 degrees. 30% chance for rain on Thursday, highs near 39. Thursday night's got a 40% chance of some rain or even some freezing rain in the forecast there. Lows down around 30. Friday's forecast has got a 40% chance of rain, looking for highs near 38 degrees. It's around 35 degrees here at Hot Country Z101.7. Now back to Tom Johnson and more holiday hoops from the Ketcham Community Center. Tom, take it away.
Thanks, Bebop and Dave. I hate it here. I put on my headset, and the first thing I heard from Bebop is freezing rain. Oh, I hate hearing those two words in January. Not only is that dangerous and I don't like driving it or having to take it off my car, it kind of affects sports schedules. You know how that goes. Kind of a double whammy for me. I don't like it, first of all, and it messes with my work schedule. So hopefully that stays away, but you know how it goes. If it starts raining, it's under 32 degrees. It's not a whole lot you can do about it. It's freezing rain, right? Hardin-Central, Princeton, 17-15. Bulldogs with the lead over the Tigers as we go into the third quarter of action here from the Ketcham Center. Final day of 2015 Holiday Hoops. Yeah, I know it's 2016, but usually refer to it the year it started. It started 15 days ago, all the way back a year ago, 2015. Pass goes inside. Kugler goes hard to the paint, and he draws a foul against Princeton with 7:45 to go in the third quarter. Foul goes against Princeton's Hunter Boxley. Neither team in serious foul trouble at all going into the second half. Boxley called for the personal. Kugler's free throw splashed. So Kugler is now up to, six. We'll go five. Five, he'll try to make it six here. Six is, there you go. 6 points for Kugler, who's a perfect 4 of 4 from the free throw line. 19-15, four-point lead for Hardin-Central, and a mental error there against Princeton. The young backcourt suffered the over and back. I didn't see exactly what happened. It looked like Duncan tried to leave that off to Jones right at the timeline. In the process of doing so, might have been bobbled right across the line back over to Hardin-Central. 24 seconds deep into the third quarter, Princeton down by four. Here is Lehman with the pass to Burton. Burton now to Gorham. Riley Gorham to Lehman in the left corner. Lehman, low block dish, goes to Estenbaum. Back to Lehman, fakes the three, drives at baseline. Hangs, shoots, misses. Weak side rebound, tip to Boxley. Hunter Boxley with it for the Tigers, fires the outlet to Berwanger. Berwanger skips up the far sideline, goes between the circles, into the hands of Jones. And Jones will go to the right wing for Duncan. Duncan now to Berwanger. Berwanger from the right elbow, spins with the dribble. Hands it off to Jones. Cameron Jones goes down the heart of the paint. Passes into the direction of Boxley. Picking off is Kugler. Kugler with the outlet pass to Lehman. Lehman up the near sideline. Fakes the drive to the baseline. Swings a pass off to Gorham. Now back to Lehman. Lehman with the basketball. Lobs it left of the key to Estenbaum. Estenbaum to the baseline for the 15-footer. It's an air ball put up by Burton. The weak side rebound grabbed by Boxley. Boxley goes up the near sideline to Milburn. Blaine Milburn with the basketball. Goes between the circles to Cameron Jones. Here's Jones going left side into the hands of Milburn. Blaine Milburn on top for Berwanger. Berwanger surveys the court and gets the ball to Duncan, who fades to the right wing. Goes on top to Boxley. Boxley to the left wing to Jones. Now back to Boxley. Left elbow jumper. Good. Hunter Boxley knocks it in for his second bucket of the ball game and makes it 19-17 Hardin-Central. 2 minutes deep into the third quarter of play. Missouri won earlier today in dominating fashion over Savannah State, 81-50. Tigers 7-6 will be at Georgia on Wednesday nights. There's a pass stolen away by Princeton, trying to go coast-to-coast with his Duncan. Runs into a double team, goes up for the shot, and had the ball stripped away. Kugler has it. He races around a Tiger all the way to the hoop, and he hits on the layup. Looked like he wanted to jam that and then decided last second, I'm not going to be able to do it. I might as well let go of the ball and hope it bounces in, and it did right off the square. 21-17. Bulldogs on top. Here's a drive and a bank shot by Milburn against the double team, and he puts it in on the 10-foot runner from the left baseline. Milburn now with 9, makes it 21-19 with 5:15 to go in the third. Timeout, Hardin-Central. It's a 2-point lead for the Bulldogs, 5:12 to go in the third quarter of play. We'll have more Holiday Hoops action coming up in 1 minute on Hot Country Z101.7 and KGOZ-TV.
Are we recording the auto shop ad?
Well, yeah, it's about time, don't you think?
True that, but the auto shop has been at 130 South Highway 65 since 2012.
Shut the front door. Jim Shaw, the best auto mechanic in the world, has been at the auto shop that long?
Yes, ma'am. Well, he's the best mechanic around my house anyway, and I wouldn't trust anyone but him and the auto shop crew under the hood of my car, and neither should you.
The auto shop, 130 South Highway 65. Give him a call today, 359-3400.
Every bushel counts, and sudden death is costing farmers as much as 9 bushels per acre. That's over $75 per acre you could be losing. This is Joe Mershman. Let's get that yield back by using Olival seed treatment from Mershman Seeds. We can add it as an option to your Mershman soybeans on those fields that have sudden death syndrome. So when the big seed companies come around, tell them thanks, but no thanks, because you've got real solutions that will make you more money from Mershman Seeds, your friend in the field.
Call Tom's Ag Spray, 875-2132.
My Party Station,
Hot Country.
A steal for Princeton as we return to action. The young backcourt got their hands on the basketball. Duncan fires it into the front court. Here's Milburn. Milburn on the dribble drive. He draws a foul against Ryan Lehman. Referee is going to get Lehman, going to let him get away with one reach. Second reach, not so much. So Lehman gets saddled there with his first foul. With the basketball for Princeton, it's Logan Duncan. Drives it inside the paint. Pass the ball to the corner for Berwanger. Goes baseline, steps inside to the defender, and hits the leaner. Thought he might have got away with steps there, but if he did, works for Princeton. 6 for Berwanger. It's 21-21 with 4.5 to go in the third. With the basketball for Hardin-Central, Matthew Burton. Passes it to Lehman. Spins it inside the paint. The runner no good, and the rebound to Boxley. Princeton starting to build momentum. Boxley gets the ball to Jones. Front court, Berwanger. He'll attack the tin. Lays it up. Misses off the back rim. Rebound, Kugler. Kugler with it for Hardin-Central. Gets the ball to Lehman. Lehman from the head of the key. Now to the elbow for Gorham. Gorham works up to the three-point arc. Gets the ball to Lehman. Lehman across the paint to Estenbaum, who misses the layup. Rebound, Kugler. He'll power it up and in. So Estenbaum missed the easy one, the tough one in traffic. Put up and in by Kugler. Kugler now has 10, and it's 23-21. 3:50 to go in the third. It's a pass off to Milburn. Free throw line jumper by Blaine. No good. Got his own rebound. Attacking the tin. Goes up for the shot. Missed. Rebound, Boxley. Goes up for the shot. Knocked out of bounds. On the way up by Hardin-Central with 3:41 to go in quarter number three. Pilot Grove and King City will finish off Holiday Hoops with a doubleheader that starts at 5:30 tonight. Girls game 5:30, boys at 7. Pass goes to Milburn. Here's Milburn now to Berwanger. Berwanger on top for Jones. Tigers attacking from right to left on the dial. Here's Jones to Milburn, now to Boxley. And a reach is going to be whistled against Kugler on the entry pass to Hunter Boxley. Kind of a cheap foul there, and I'm sure Coach Kenny Lehman feels the same way. As Cliff Kugler gets called for his third personal foul on a little reach 15 feet away, didn't need to do it, and got hit with an important call, his third foul of the night. Pass comes inbounds, and it's stolen away, going in coast to coast for the jam. For Hardin-Central is Cliff Kugler. Had a chance at the jam earlier and kind of missed time to steps. That time, not so much. He flushes it down for two. And it's 25-21, Hardin-Central. 3:13 to go in the third. Princeton with the basketball. Here's Logan Duncan. Duncan gets the ball off to Milburn. Free throw line jumper off the rim. Goes after his own rebound. Couldn't get it. Tries to save it in bounds. Unable to do so. The ball out of bounds over to Hardin-Central High School. So the Bulldogs have rebuilt the lead up to a couple of buckets. 25-21, 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. Here's Lehman with it, goes left side to Burton. Burton to Lehman, fires the three ball. A little strong, no good, weak side rebound Boxley. Outlet pass, it leads Duncan, he flies front court, gets the ball to Berwanger, layup good, perfect fast break. Perfect pass to Duncan, perfect pass to Berwanger, spins it in for two. Calvin with eight, and it's 25-23. Hardin-Central, Lehman with it, lobs the ball to Kugler. Kugler, low block, nice pass for the layup attempt, blocked on the way up, Estenbaum, and the rebound taken by Princeton. Jones to Duncan. Duncan drives and has his shot blocked, and it hit him on the shoulder as he was standing out of bounds. I think that's going to be Hardin-Central basketball, and it is. 2:19 to go in the third quarter. Opportunity for the tie for Princeton goes by the side of the road. As Hardin-Central takes it the other way with a two-point lead. Left to right on your dial come the Bulldogs. From the left baseline, Lehman, his pass stolen away by Berwanger. Calvin playing a brilliant third quarter, gets the ball to Duncan. He drives, fades inside the paint, has his shot hit the front of the rim, no good, but a foul whistled against Hardin-Central with 2 minutes to go in the third. Foul will be whistled against Riley Gorham of Hardin-Central, his second, and Duncan goes to the free throw line and cans the charity toss. Duncan's been active today for Princeton, but he had yet to score until that free throw, but he's been a bundle of energy flying up and down the floor. He's had a lot of layup opportunities, things like that, kind of crawl off the rim. Has to feel good for him to get a couple of free throws with nobody in his face. Duncan hits both free throws, and we're nodded at. Quarter of 100 apiece, 25 for the Tigers, 25 for the Bulldogs. Under 2 minutes to go in the third quarter on Z101.7. Ball loose at the timeline, diving on it is Milburn. Ball grabbed just in the nick of time by Hardin-Central's Estenbaum. Estenbaum gets the ball to Lehman, now he lost it. Ball picked away by Princeton as he tried to get the ball on the deck to start the fast break. Cameron Jones walked. So Princeton is making life really difficult right now with that youthful speed and exuberance from the backcourt. Almost forcing a turnover there. Here's Gorham. Works right side. Ball knocked away. Gorham gets it on over to Lehman. Lehman to the elbow. Hangs down the paint. Draws contact. He just kind of hurtled his body into a couple of Princeton defenders hoping to get the whistle, and he does. So that'll send Lehman to the free throw line with 92 seconds to go in the third quarter. Really a game today. Both teams have been allowed to play. Not a lot of whistles in this one. So if you're going to get a whistle, you got to earn it. Ryan Lehman gets his first point of the third quarter. He's up to 12. 26-25. Bulldogs. Second free throw. That one's good. Ryan Lehman hits a pair. 27-25, Hardin-Central, Princeton with the ball, buck and a half to go, third quarter. Here's Cameron Jones with it for the Tigers, gets a high screen, takes the ball to the right elbow, to the corner for Berwanger, three balls short on the rim, no good, and the rebound to the orange and black. Tommy Burton gets the ball off to the point guard, Ryan Lehman. Lehman veers to the left side, gets the ball off of the chest high pass to Burton, back to Lehman. Lehman inside making the catch is Estenbaum and reaching there on the entry pass. Called for the foul is Princeton's Calvin Berwanger. Second foul against Calvin. Team foul number three in the second half against Princeton. Andrew Smith checks in for Calvin Berwanger for the Tigers. From the right baseline, Lehman tosses it in along the far hash to Gorham. Now to Lehman, flashes into the corner, fakes the three ball. Drives, hangs, shoots, bank shot hit the side of the backboard. And the ball is knocked out of bounds by Hardin-Central. Looked like Boxley's trying to grab that ball. He lost it out of the bounds, was the question was. Was it deflected by Hardin-Central or was it not? They're going to say yes, it was deflected by Hardin-Central. Got just a couple of cat calls from some of the Bulldog faithful that have made their way up to Grundy County from Ray County today. 50 seconds to go in the third. The ball goes back over to Princeton. Here is Jones driving, dishing to the wing. Duncan's three for the lead. Off the iron, no good. Rebound, Kugler. Kugler gets the outlet pass to Estenbaum. Now to Lehman. Lehman lobs the ball baseline. Nice catch by Gorham. Gets it inside to Kugler, and he lost the ball in traffic. Ball taken away by Princeton. Here's Milburn. Races up the near sideline. Fires it into the corner for Jones. Jones off to Jones. Three ball good. It was Andrew Smith. Cameron Jones for three. Cameron Jones now has five, and it's 28-27 Tigers. 17 seconds to go in the third quarter. Lehman with the basketball for the orange and black. Goes between the rings to Gorham. Now Gorham to the left wing for Burton. Inside to Kugler. Hangs, shoots, spins it up. No. Got his own rebound. Lays it up and in. Staying with that is Kugler to get the bucket. He has 10 points in the quarter, 14 in the game. Three-pointer from two-thirds court, no good at the horn by Princeton's Logan Duncan. At the end of three, it's Hardin-Central 29, Princeton 28. Fourth quarter's up in a minute on KGOZ.
Right now at Kohl's and Kohl's.com, take 25% off Nike apparel, shoes, and accessories for everyone in your family during Kohl's 25% off Nike sale. Plus, everyone gets $10 Kohl's cash for every $50 spent. But hurry, Kohl's 25% off Nike sale ends Saturday. Shop now, online, and in stores. Make your move. Kohl's. Select styles, promotional offers, and coupons do not apply. See store or Kohl's.com for details.
You could spend a dollar in that app on your phone. Buy yourself some digital gold coins. Although converting actual money into imaginary money isn't the shrewdest investment strategy. Maybe get a Crunchwrap slider at Taco Bell instead. Four delicious flavors like Sriracha Chicken and Spicy Beefy Nacho for just a buck each. They're real and real delicious. Crunchwrap sliders for a dollar. Only at Taco Bell. At participating locations for a limited time. Prices may vary. Tax extra.
Princeton Tiger basketball on KGOZ, Gallatin, Chillicothe.
8 minutes go up on the clock, fourth quarter underway. Princeton down to points with the basketball for the Tigers. Logan Duncan goes right side to Andrew Smith. Smith finds Cameron Jones, and the freshman dribbles the ball toward the timeline. Goes left of the key for Milburn. Milburn now to the high free throw line to Duncan. Goes right down the defense, and Logan lays it in for two. Kind of opened up there like the old proverbial Red Sea. Moses parting the waters for Princeton as Logan Duncan gets his first field goal of the game. 30-29, Tigers on top. 30 seconds deep into the fourth quarter. Here's Lehman. Pass it to Kugler. Kugler going to work. Low block. Shot blocked in there by Boxley. Loose ball taken baseline by Estenbaum. Back inside to Kugler. He's double teamed. Kugler right of the circle. Into the corner for Estenbaum. Estenbaum cross-court pass to Lehman. Back inside to Kugler. Boy, Hardin-Central has big Cliff Kugler in there, and they're feeding him the rock at all times, trying to take advantage of that size advantage, and there was a push. 0-7 to go in the fourth quarter. Second free throw coming on up for Kugler. Up and good. Kugler knocks them both down. He has all 4 points in the fourth quarter, and Hardin-Central has opened up a 33-30 lead over the Princeton Tigers. 6 minutes to go in regulation. Big possession here for Princeton. Pass goes baseline to Boxley. Now to Milburn. Milburn head and shoulder fake. Takes the ball to the left wing. Pass the ball to the freshman Logan Duncan. He splits the double team. Goes into the paint. Didn't have much of an angle for a shot, but drew the foul. That'll send Duncan to the free throw line with 5:52 to go. Lehman called for the personal foul. His seconds. Team's fourth of the half. Logan Duncan, 2 of 4 from the free throw line, make it 3 of 5. He went 0 of 2 from the line in the first half. Now he's 3 of 3 in the second half. Timeout's going to be called here by head coach Mike Creekmore. Tigers down by two, 5:52 to go. We're back in 30 seconds on Z101.7.
We just found out about this great business.
Hot Country Z101.7.
Little Walk the Moon coming out of break here as we come down the home stretch in the fourth quarter of this Princeton Hardin-Central doubleheader. Lady Tigers won earlier. Princeton boys down by one as the second free throw makes it a one-point game off the palm of Logan Duncan. Logan Duncan now is six all in the second half. 33-32. Hardin-Central with a one-point lead. Flashing to the head of the key as Riley Gorme gets the basketball. Swings it to the right side to Estenbaum. Estenbaum to the high post to Kugler. Kugler backs beyond the arc and will hand the ball off to Lehman. He steps into a three ball. Missed it off the iron. Rebound loose on the floor. Grabbed in the corner off the deflection by Estenbaum. Gets it to Kugler. Down the paint he goes. Yang shoots. And the scoop shot is up and good. Ryan Lehman with the scoopage. Able to put it in 5 feet away from the right side, and it's 35-32 Hardin-Central with 5:10 to go in the fourth quarter. With the basketball, Jones gets it to Duncan, now back to Jones. Jones to the elbow, down the paint, hangs, and his shot swatted away. Thought Jones going to be able to draw some contact, maybe get a three-point play, and Kugler said, no, I'm bigger, I'm stronger, and I'm just going to hammer this ball out of bounds. He did exactly that. From the left baseline, pass will come in bounds from Cameron Jones. Pass tipped to the free throw line, taken by Hardin-Central. Costly turnover there by the Tigers with the basketball, Ryan Lehman. Lehman from the three-point arc will take the ball to the left wing. Picks up the dribble, launches the three. It's no good off the back iron. Rebound tipped and grabbed by Hardin-Central. Put back no good by Estenbaum. Deflected out of bounds by Princeton. It will stay Bulldog ball with 4:44 to go in the third, in the fourth quarter. Here's Lehman from the right baseline. Looking, still looking. Fires the ball off to Burton. Back to Lehman. Lehman right side, one-on-one. And he gets the foul call. Little pump fake there. Got Blaine Milburn in the air. Once Lehman had that, he jumped right into Milburn. That'll get you a call every time. Why? You stay on your feet. You don't bite on those pump fakes. Milburn did. He gets a second foul. Free throw by Lehman is good. Solid all-around game here for Ryan Lehman of Hardin-Central. His team up by four. Make it five as he hits both free throws. So Lehman hits a pair, 37-32. Tigers down five. Milburn lays the ball off to Jones. Jones goes right side to Berwanger. Berwanger now to Duncan. Duncan to Berwanger. Berwanger will lob it to Boxley. Boxley from the extended elbow on top. Three ball up and good. Swished by Logan Duncan. So Duncan having the second consecutive big second half as many games here at the Ketcham Center for Princeton. Did the same thing 2 weeks ago. Pass goes low block to Kugler, misses the shot, fights for the rebound, has it, puts it back up, misses. Rebound, Estenbaum back to Kugler, his set shot, no good. Rebound, loose on the floor, grabbed by Princeton, then grabbed at the timeline as a foul is whistled against Hardin-Central. Logan Duncan got to the ball, got knocked to the floor as a foul is going to be whistled against Tommy Burton. Five opportunities for Hardin-Central there, and not a one of them would go in. Burton called for his second foul as the pass goes off to the right wing to Berwanger. Berwanger lobs it to Boxley. Boxley now left side pass deflected right back to Hunter. He gets it right of the key. Shot by Berwanger off the back iron. No good. Rebound Bulldogs. Pulling it down inside Tommy Burton. Burton dribbles it baseline away from the pressure of Boxley and hands the ball off to Lehman. Lehman handling the rock for Hardin-Central. Zigzags into the front court. Lobs the ball baseline. Kugler. Powers it up over Boxley and misses. Ball hit him right in the head and bounces out of bounds right back over to Princeton. Boxley gave him the layup because he realized that Cliff had no angle. Ball hit the bottom of the rim, came back hard and hit him right on the noggin and went back out of bounds. 37-35, Hardin-Central at the lead. Princeton with the ball, 3:18 to go in the fourth quarter. Pass goes to the right wing. Here's Logan Duncan. Duncan off to Milburn. Milburn goes right side. He'll leave the ball off for Duncan. Three ball, in and out, no good. And the rebound to Gorham. Gorham double team baseline, fires it underneath his own hoop to Lehman. Now up the sideline into the hands of Burton. Burton to Lehman. Hardin-Central sets up the half court offense. 3 minutes to go in the fourth. Here's Lehman driving, pulling up, shooting, missing over Milburn. Rebound and the putback. Good. Hard rebound and a better putback by Ryler Estenbaum. He gets a second bucket of the ballgame, and it's a big one for Hardin-Central. 39-35, Bulldogs pass goes to Duncan. Feeds it into the near corner, grabbed there by Milburn. Milburn fakes and delivers it off to Jones. Jones low block to Smith. Smith goes up for the shot, misses it wide of the rim. And the rebound to Hardin-Central. Gorham gets the ball to Lehman. 2:23 to go in the fourth quarter. Hunter Boxley will be in at the next whistle for Coach Creekmore. With the ball, fading left side is Lehman. Lehman picks up the dribble and goes right of the key for Gorham. Gorham to the low block to Estenbaum. Back to Gorham. Now to Lehman. 2 minutes to go. Hardin-Central with a four-point lead over Princeton. 39-35. With it, Lehman picks up the dribble, passes off to Burton. Burton goes left of the key to Estenbaum. Back to Burton. Burton jumped into by Princeton's Blaine Milburn. Nothing called. Princeton goes for a steal, and we get a foul whistled against Logan Duncan of the Tigers. Foul against Logan will be his first. Team foul number 7. Big free throw here for Tommy Burton, who's scoreless today for Hardin-Central. He gets a 1-1 with his team up by 4. 1:45 to go. Free throw, no. Off the rim, rebound. Princeton lost it out of bounds. Couple of Tigers went for that rebound to the two experienced guys on the front line, Boxley and Milburn, and they knocked the ball away from one another. So it's out of bounds, stays with Hardin-Central. Pass goes into the right corner for Estenbaum, now to Burton. Burton to the high post to Lehman. It's really been the Lehman and Kugler show as far as scoring goes for Hardin-Central here in the second half. I'd say if anybody else gets the ball for Hardin-Central and your Princeton, foul them, put some pressure on the other guys. Here's Estenbaum getting the ball to Lehman, now to Gorham, back to Lehman. Lehman with it, front of the timeline. He'll take the ball under the left side, dribbles through the pressure, goes into the corner, draws a double team, gets the ball off to Estenbaum, now to Gorham. Gorham to the right side to Burton. Burton drives it, pass stolen away by Berwanger. Berwanger has it up the near sideline. He'll pass it off to Milburn. He goes for the layup. Pretty good reach in there. I thought Riley Gorham got a lot of ball, but the foul is whistled on the reach. It may be Gorham. Called for the reach and foul, and it is. They say Agoram, along with getting the ball, got a piece of wrist. Third foul against Riley Gorham brings a timeout. 1:03 to go. Princeton down 4. We're back in 30 seconds on KGOZ and KGOZ TV.
Big G Foodland in Princeton is a longtime proud supporter of their hometown Princeton Tigers. For tailgating before the next Tiger game, swing by Big G, always featuring great deals on your favorites, like ribs and beef. Visit BigGFoodland.com to see the latest ad specials, recipes, and ways to eat smarter and healthier. Big G Foodland, conveniently located at 107 North Washington Street in Princeton, says go Tigers.
Go.
My party station.
Hot Country, Z101.7.
1:03 to go in the fourth quarter. The score, with Princeton facing a huge possession here. Hardin-Central 39, Princeton 35. Princeton will be at Maysville to begin GRC play Friday night of next week. We'll be there, weather permitting, because I did hear two words I hate to hear in the January forecast earlier, freezing rain right about that time. I think that might have been Thursday night, but still. Weather permitting, Princeton at Maysville Friday on KTTN-FM 92.3. Ball goes left corner for Berwanger of the Tigers. 1 minute to go. Gets cut off on the baseline. Lobs it inside to Milburn. Goes to the right baseline and lays it in for two. Blaine Milburn with the bucket. That slices the Bulldog lead to two. 50 seconds to go. With the basketball, Lehman lobs it front court. Catch made by Burton. Burton back to Lehman. Almost a travel. Princeton fans wanted one. Didn't get one. Here's Lehman playing a game of keep away on the dribble. Lehman goes into the corner for Estenbaum. Back to Lehman. Lehman, left side now to Burton. Burton makes the catch and he's fouled. Good play there by Princeton. Princeton did not get the turnover, but they put Tommy Burton, who's 0 for 1 from the line, has not scored today. They put him on the line, which forces a guy who hasn't scored to make free throws instead of Ryan Lehman, who's been probably the best player on the floor today for either side. So Tommy Burton steps to the line. He missed a free throw about a minute ago. This one is up, and that one no good off the back rim. And the rebound claimed by Princeton. Two misses now by Burton. The rebound to Duncan. Duncan works to the front court for the Tigers. Tigers down by two as the pass goes off to Milburn. 22 seconds to go. He gives it off to Duncan. Duncan into the hands of Jones. Now to Milburn. Milburn to the high post to Berwanger. Berwanger dribble drives down the heart of the paint, puts up the runner, banks it off the iron, no good. And the rebound claimed by Hardin-Central with 9.4 seconds to go. Hit the back rim, bounced out. Tommy Burton got the tough rebound for Hardin-Central, and here we go again. Tommy Burton's going to go to the free throw line. He's kind of smiling off his free throw difficulties. He has that big smile on his face. Coach is kind of saying, just relax. Just take a deep breath. Do what you do in practice. He's kind of nodding and saying, I know, coach. So Burton goes to line, 1-1. 2-point lead for Hardin-Central. Free throw by Burton. That one is up, and that one is swished. Kind of almost had his legs give way as it went through, as if he said, finally. Boy, that felt good. Burton hits the free throw. He's now 1-3 from the line. This would be a big one and make it a 4-point lead for Hardin-Central. If this one misses, Princeton could tie on a three. That free throw bounces off, no good. Rebound clicks right back to Burton. And he's fouled with 7.9 seconds to go. It hung on the rim, about a two-second little time delay there. And as it came down, did not catch who the player was for Hardin-Central, but somebody for Hardin-Central tipped it back to the free throw line, and that's where Burton was waiting for the shot that missed. A huge opportunity missed there for Princeton. Princeton now needs to hope for some free throw misses for Hardin-Central and at least a three ball to send it into overtime. It's Hardin-Central 40 and Princeton 37. 7.9 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. Princeton girls won earlier today, 40-37. Had to look at that. That doesn't happen very often. The girls' final was 40-37, and I look up at the current score in the boys' game. It's 40-37. I had this quick surge of deja vu, like I had just seen that score, because I had. So these games have been very similar as far as the final scores are going to be, assuming that this boys' game does not go overtime. Hardin-Central's Ryler. Nope, it's not going to be Estenbaum. It is going to be Tommy Burton going back to the free throw line this time. This is a big break for Hardin-Central this time. Burton shoots two. That is the 10th team foul against Princeton just a moment ago. Third against Logan Duncan. Free throw up and good. Drilled by Tommy Burton. Now Princeton, I won't toss the term miracle out, but Princeton's going to need a lot of good things to happen in a short amount of time. 8 seconds to go. 4-point lead. Hardin-Central, second free throw for Burton. That one swished. So Burton's getting his confidence from the line. He knocks a couple in. Here's Milburn. He'll take the ball to the timeline. Princeton down five. Pass goes to the corner. Berwanger fires a three, and that's going to do it. It comes up short on the rim, and Princeton, pretty good ball game back and forth here today at the Ketcham Center. Falls by five to Hardin-Central. Final score, the Hardin-Central Bulldogs 42 and the Princeton Tigers 37. We'll be back with a scoring summary and wrap up this doubleheader in 2 minutes on Hot Country Z101.7 and KGOZ-TV.
North Central Missouri College is proud to be a sponsor of high school athletes playing on area sports teams. As NCMC observes its 90th anniversary, we are proud of NCMC's strong legacy and continued growth. If you're thinking of returning to college, NCMC is an excellent choice with newly expanded online degree programs and highly competitive tuition. Visit ncmissouri.edu. Call 359-3948. Learn how NCMC can prepare you for the future.
We are Missouri Farm Bureau Insurance, and we're for home sweet home. We're for condos, tutors, single wides, and studios. We're for ranches, houseboats, two stories or 20.
Red cedar, bluebirds, white squirrels, black walnuts, whatever's out your back door, we're for that. We're for watching the sun rise over the Mississippi and set over the Missouri. We're for kicking off your heels in a high rise or hanging up your hat in the boot heel. And if you have a home in Missouri, we have a policy for you.
I'm Marcia Cox, your Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent. And if you're in Mercer County, I've got you covered.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What? Are we recording a new auto shop ad?
Well, yeah, it's about time, don't you think?
True that, but the auto shop has been at 130 South Highway 65 since 2012.
Shut the front door. Jim Shaw, the best auto mechanic in the world, has been at the auto shop that long?
Yes, ma'am. Well, he's the best mechanic around my house anyway, and I wouldn't trust anyone but him and the auto shop crew under the hood of my car, and neither should you.
The auto shop, 130 South Highway 65. Give him a call today, 359-3400.
No question about it, weeds were bad this year, and they ended up costing you a lot of yield. Our solution for 2016 is LibertyLink soybeans. This is Joe Mershman. By using the LibertyLink system from Mershman Seeds, you can control those tough weeds, and you and I both know that no weeds mean big yields. So when the big seed companies come around, tell them thanks, but no thanks, because you've got real solutions that will make you more money from Mershman Seeds, your friend in the field.
Call Tom's Ag Spray, 875-2132.
Hot Country Z101.7.
Welcome back here to the Ketcham Community Center. The final score in this boys basketball contest: the Princeton Tigers fall 5 points short, getting the doubleheader sweep, falling to the Hardin-Central Bulldogs 42-37. It was 8-4 Bulldogs after one. And after both teams scored 11 points in the second quarter, it was, and let me correct that, it was 19-17 at the half. Princeton trailed by two, so it was 13-11 Princeton with the advantage in the second quarter. 13-10, Princeton outscored Hardin-Central in the third, but the fourth quarter did end the Tigers. Tigers had difficulty finding the bottom of the hoop in the fourth quarter. Hardin-Central, kind of generally a bigger and stronger team than Princeton, was able to kind of grab their will a little bit in this game, so to speak, in the fourth quarter. Held Princeton to 7 fourth quarter points. Hardin-Central got a few free throws late. Granted, it was 13-7 Hardin-Central with the advantage in the fourth quarter. Final score 42-37. Hardin-Central led today by the 1-2 punch. Have you seen Hardin-Central play? I'm sure this is going to be the way it is for Hardin-Central. You got some role players. You got Mr. Outside. You got Mr. Inside. Mr. Outside, Ryan Lehman, he finishes his day with 17 points. Mr. Inside, Cliff Kugler, he ends up with 18. So that duo with 35 of the 42 points for Hardin-Central. But when Hardin-Central needed some points late to close out Princeton, had to lean on the free throw shooting of Tommy Burton. Had some anxious moments early in that fourth quarter. Missed a couple to give Princeton opportunities. But Burton able to close out Princeton by hitting three of his last four free throws. So that role player for Hardin-Central had three awfully big points. And Ryler Estenbaum ends up with a field goal in the first quarter. Field goal in the fourth quarter. He ends up with four for Hardin-Central. Princeton was paced today by Blaine Milburn. He ends up with 11. 9 points for Logan Duncan. 8 for Calvin Berwanger. 5 points for Cameron Jones. And 4 points for Hunter Boxley. Final score in our broadcast today: the Princeton girls defeat Hardin-Central 40-37. Hardin-Central boys defeat Princeton 42-37. Again for Hardin-Central, Cliff Kugler with 18 and Ryan Lehman with 17. And for Princeton, Blaine Milburn with 11. Coming up next week, Mercer at Southwest Livingston. Doubleheader action Tuesday nights. KTTN-FM 92.3. On Wednesday night, NCMC women's basketball, first game of 2016, will be at Kansas City, Kansas Community College. I believe that's a 5 o'clock tip. Make it about 4:45 pregame on KGOZ on Wednesday night. Friday night, wall-to-wall high school basketball. Weather permitting, it will be Princeton at Maysville on KTTN 92.3 FM and Trenton at Brookfield on Hot Country Z101.7. Doubleheader split today from Holiday Hoops between the Tigers and the Bulldogs. Hardin-Central boys win by 5. Princeton girls won by 3. How about the similar final scores? 40-37 girls final for Princeton. 42-37 boys final for Hardin-Central. Holiday Hoops wraps up here in the next 3 hours at the Ketcham Center. If you're in the area, you want to see the final two games of this always superb event, The Pilot Grove Tigers going to take on the King City Wildcats. Grand River Conference girls and boys teams taking on a squad, Pilot Grove, from down, I believe, in the Columbia area, down there in the kind of the I-70 corridor in central Missouri. Princeton and Hardin-Central split the doubleheader today. Lafayette beat Kirksville in an earlier girls matchup here at Holiday Hoops, 42-31. That wraps up our broadcast on Hot Country Z101.7. Thanks to studio engineer Bebop and Dave Berkey-Bile. And for our videographer, bringing you the video today on KGOZ-TV, that's Logan Demsich. Tom Johnson from NCMC Holiday Hoops. Congratulations to the folks here for a great 11th annual event. Two more games to go between Pilot Grove and King City from downtown Trenton. Tom Johnson signing off here on Hot Country Z101.7. Enjoy your first Saturday night of the new year.